What's up, guys? Welcome to Fresh Fit Podcast. After Hours Edition, we got a packed house.
Too much people here. God damn!
Too many people. Let's get into it.
All right.
Gotcha. You guys thought we weren't work here.
We are back.
Hey, welcome to Fresh Fit Podcast After Hours Edition, guys. We got a great show planned for you today. We got a packed house, so packed that me and Fresh are almost off the podcast table ourselves.
Yep. But because tomorrow we won't be doing any show or Sunday.
Yes.
So
yes.
We will not. Enjoy now.
So quick announcements, guys. Number one, we will do a show Monday. We're going to have our lawyer in the house, Jen, and her husband, Dan, and we're going to talk about Bill Cosby getting released. The whole Me Too era and how to protect yourself from false allegations. That's going to be Monday at 6 p.m. Set your calendars. Also, we're going to be on Timcast IRL on Tuesday, guys. So make sure to tune in there because we are colliding pretty much. I mean, that's a crazy collab.
That's going to be a crazy collab, man.
Yeah.
They're going to challenge us.
Yeah, they are going to probably challenge our views. But nah.
Tell us. Who knows?
They're in the middle. So they're going to be like, oh, okay, I see your point. All right, cool. Anyway, continuing on. So with that said, guys, patreon.com/freshfit. Where we have all the behind the scenes content. If you guys want to see us kicking out all the Ratchet Girls on WorldStar that wasn't safe enough for YouTube, it's on there. Also, guys, Zoom calls. So you know, we do one weekly Zoom call where we talk about fitness, finances, and girls. We also talk about investing. We talk about crypto, real estate, all that stuff. As you guys know, me and Fresh are both involved in crypto and real estate. I just closed my third property for the year yesterday. And then on top of that, I'm under contract for another property. So, hey, man, and Fresh has got his iced out rolly. So, guys,
not today though.
Yeah, you don't got it on today. Don't want to get off. No, I'm just kidding. But in general, we teach you guys how to manage your money better so that anything that you do buy, you can turn it into some kind of asset.
That's it.
So that's what we're all about, guys. So we don't just teach you how to womanize, we teach you how to make money as well. Also, what else?
We got the course live right now, yes. Guys.
DMs on Demand is live, guys. DMsOnDemandSystem.com. If you're tired of getting curbed by girls,
yep,
go ahead, sign up. It's only going to be open for 7 days. So get in now. We have 23 modules in there. 40 hours plus of content. We teach you guys how to DM girls, how to take pictures, how to do stories, how to run ads to get girls, how to use captions, how to do everything on Instagram to include networking.
And 2-hour long Zoom calls. This is the best Instagram course ever made on the planet.
3 Zoom calls, guys.
Yeah.
Three Zoom calls.
This covers branding, business acumen, how to network, and get girls. You can't find that anywhere else, guys.
Because I'll be honest, guys, in today's day and age, your Instagram account is like your business card, and a lot of girls will curve you if your Instagram is trash. So, and you guys will see you later today when we do our Snatch or Pass. So, we teach you guys how to put your best foot forward so that you can minimize getting curved, I guess.
Left on scene.
Yeah, exactly. Get on the scene or get left on scene.
There you go.
That's a new slogan.
Twitch.
Twitch.tv/FreshFitPodcast, guys. Make sure to open up another tab, close the Pornhub tab, all right? And then type in twitch.tv/FreshFitPodcast. Listen to it. Watch us on there because actually the quality is better. So you can see the titties in 1080p. And yeah, because I know why you thirsty niggas are in here. And then we got twitch.tv, Aaron Poxon. That's our boy, Chris. He is our producer. He's also going to start doing his own Twitch channel where he's playing video games and reacting on other stuff. So show him some support.
And we got the vlog channel, man. I just posted a new vlog this morning. So go watch the vlog. It's crazy. You see behind the scenes of the studio, when we travel, dates, and everything in between.
Exactly. So you guys can see all the behind the scenes of the craziness that happens. And for all you guys that complain that we always start late, you'll see why we start late. So much goes into this, guys. You don't even know. There's a reason why all the top podcasts don't live stream. None of them. The only person that live streams is Timcast.
Yep.
Everyone else is pre-recorded for a fucking reason. This shit's hard. All right. Super chats real quick. And then we're going to introduce lovely ladies.
Black Wolf Inc. Fellas, it's time for the Fresh and Fit drinking game. If the ladies cap, say light more than once or assume they're equal to men, drink. Your blood alcohol levels will be over 9,000. Let the cap-in begin.
Yeah, I don't know if you guys want to do that. You will die. It's
over 9,000. You literally will die of poisoning.
Why is that girl wearing shades indoors? You got a response to that?
Oh, why are you
wearing my sunglasses at night?
I just think they looked really cool. No other reason.
Okay.
She said, fuck you, motherfucker. You got to come a little harder than that. They're going to clown you. All right, Kazanari, $5 super sticker. Thank you so much.
Oh, Bill Cosby.
Hey, shout out to you, Bill Cosby. You out. My cellmate put me on to y'all. It's good to be free. Hit my line. I'll slide through for Monday. Yellow bone, snow bunnies only for the after party show.
Bill, you can't drug him, though. Wait, pause.
Shout out to Bill Cosby. Daryl Blake, like the video. It literally takes just a second. Guys,
Bex,
please like the video. Also, guys, subscribe to our Fresh and Fit Clips channel. Guys, I was on that channel looking. Yeah. 85% of you motherfuckers are not subscribed to that channel, and you guys are watching it. So like the video,
yo,
comment, subscribe.
Who's Nina underrated?
Nina, she's a big fitness person. I met her in Crunch Gym, actually, a few years back. So shout out to Nina, by the way, for showing love on YouTube.
Yeah,
thank you for showing love.
It's up to our channel.
Guys, do us a favor. If you support us, just open up a new tab, type in Fresh and Fit Clips. You can get the podcast in like 5 to 10 minute chunks. It's easy to access. And once again, this is a 1 hour, 2 hour stream. So it's much easier to like digest.
Yeah. So yeah, check us out there, guys. It's going to be much better. It's awesome because you get in like 7 to 15 minute bits. But anyway, without further ado,
we got one more here.
Oh, another one? Okay, last one.
$19.86, $25. I'm excited about tonight's podcast. You guys are now part of my primetime entertainment. Thank you, brother. The New World Order of Masculinity. And cool.
All right.
And then he says, let's go.
Dan trying to maintain abundance mindset, but I feel the sim coming out. Okay. Dan, yeah, trying to.
It's going
to
be hard, bro.
And then, okay, new member. Thank you for becoming a new member.
Thank you.
All right, let's get into it.
Cool. Guys, for 20 and up.
20 and up from here? Okay.
Cool. So, ladies, just introduce yourselves, your first name, your social, your government. No, I'm just kidding. But just say your name, your age, what you do for a living, and your current dating status. We'll start here.
Well, my name is Hannah. I'm 21.
21.
Very single, very, very single. And I sell health insurance for a living.
Okay. Cool. Shout out to you.
My name is Genuine. I'm 24.
Are you genuine, though?
I am pretty genuine. I'm going to tell you what I feel. Ask me something.
No. You go ahead. You go ahead.
Okay. Oh. I'm 24. And what I do now, I'm a stage actress right now. I like to travel and do stage acting.
Oh, dope.
It's fun.
And your current dating status?
Oh, I'm single.
All right. Cool. All right, next.
Hi, y'all. I'm Batty. Batty OG on Instagram. I am 25 years old. And I model. Yeah.
And Batty, this is Chris.
Okay, cool.
Batty, I want to see your eyes. Can you please take off the shades for me, please? I didn't know you put those dark shades on.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. All right, next.
There you go.
My name is Soto. I am 21, and I am currently unemployed because I am a student at a university in Colorado. And I'm
fun employment. Fun employment.
I'm very, very single. Yes.
Cool. There you go. All right, and then next.
Hi, I'm Aaliyah Nicole.
Welcome back.
Hi, yes, I've been here before. I'm a singer, songwriter, actress. I'm 25, and I am single.
All right, awesome. All right, next.
Hi, I'm LV. I'm also a singer, songwriter, but I live in Haiti, and I got like a screen printing factory clothing stuff going on over there.
And you flew in to get to the show today, right?
That's your flew in today.
I flew in today, literally like
from Haiti.
30 minutes ago.
That's crazy.
And yeah, I'm also single.
Okay, cool. Awesome. All right, next. Welcome back.
Hey guys. Hey. I'm SJ. I'm 23.
you forgot your age. God,
no,
yeah.
It's just like different reasons. 23. I do taxes.
Sure, no watching.
I do taxes in the day, but at night I spit on the mic.
Oh shit.
Oh, you spit on the mic?
Real good, yeah, I do.
Hot fire.
Oh, wait, what are we talking about?
All right, cool. Next. Welcome back.
Thank you, guys. Hi, my name is Gabriella. I am 29. I'm an accountant, not a TikTok accountant, an actual accountant. I am single. Yes.
Cool.
I'm Jillian. I do OnlyFans.
Welcome back to Miami, Jillian.
I'm back.
From Puerto Rico.
Yes, and I'm 20 years old.
Cool. Shout out to you.
She's 21, guys. No, I'm just kidding.
21.
She's drinking water.
okay. So we're two super chats or no?
Yeah, we can. It's 20 and up. So, okay. Nolan Baptiste, $20. I hate how people lied about Bill Cosby, and he has every right to be angry at society. But what do you think, Myron? We're going to cover it on Monday, tune in at 6 p.m. Mr. Obi-Wan, 2020, finally caught you guys live. Blue collar, 27 years old, pulling in $65,000 a year in Alaska, saving for building my own shop and getting into rental properties. Keep with the good work.
Awesome, y'all. Man. Good job.
Yeah, save that money out there and then get the fuck out of Alaska when you can.
Yep.
Face, $20. First time donating ever. Just like the video. I watch y'all so much, I didn't realize we live. Yeah, man.
Bro.
Like the goddamn video, man.
Likes are free, man. Like, look. We give you guys a great show for free. At least we do is like the video, man. I mean, come on.
And real talk, guys, the reason why we push you guys to like the video so much, just so you guys know, the kind of content that we put out is very controversial.
Yep.
Okay. People report us all the time for being misogynistic or whatever the fuck they want to say because we spit facts.
Yep.
So for us to win an algorithm, you need to like the video so it keeps us going because we have so many crazy feminists that, dude, I get death threats from feminists every day. Real talk. So guys, like the video, support us because it helps the content get out to other guys to keep them from putting a fucking gun in their mouth.
There you go.
Help us out with that.
All right, Nisa, $100. Thank you, brother. I'm recently divorced, caught my wife for 7 years cheating on me. Damn. I fell into a depression that I felt like I couldn't get out of. Listening to you guys has given me a new outlook on life. I need to smash your pass. Be brutally honest for me, girls. Captain Foreskin.
Okay. Well, we'll save that name.
Save that one. Yeah. Guys, tonight we will be doing Smash Your Pass. Chris, what's the number for Smash Your Pass?
We'll do it for 50.
Yeah, 50 tonight.
50. Cool. Okay, so unless it gets crazy. All right, your future ain't that bright. Take off those shades. Oh, shit. You got a rebuttal?
Shit.
Suck my dick.
Oh! There we go.
Kill him!
All right, Aunt Jemima, 20 hours fresh. You can get flued out. Just want to drizzle syrup over them feet. Forget the meat. I'll be...
Nah, nigga. I'm a fly girl. I'm not getting flued out. Nah, I'll fly around here.
It's Aunt Jemima, bro. You don't
want to do it? I'm a pay the tab, bro.
Okay. Lonnie Lavelle.
Chris always does that shit to me.
Yeah, well, come on, Lonnie Lavelle, $20. These two ladies next to Fit, I'm curious if they date black men with a foot fetish.
Oh, do you? They date black men with
the two Latinas.
I really find it weird, the foot fetish thing, considering I walk on those. But I don't know. But yeah, I date colored men.
Okay.
Very politically correct. And then what about you?
Yeah, I wouldn't have a problem.
Okay.
There you go. Slide in their DMs.
All right. BBC, niggas.
But I wouldn't say that you got a foot fetish off rip because that's going to have trigger them and they're going to think like,
we talk.
Okay. Namel Troxler. I'm tall, dark, and handsome, plus in shape, but only fat chicks approach me.
Okay, bro.
Hey, man. It happens.
Hey, man.
It happens to the best of us, man. King Dravon, $20. Ask the ladies, are they average? Is an average man good enough for them? We'll get there. Don't worry. Cool. Black Wolfing, $20. Well, I guess I'm going to super imp tonight. Six of the nine ladies are what I would want for a wife. Mock me if you want. Ninja Watchers. Okay.
Hey, man. You like what you like, bro.
Stefan Below, y'all got anything to say about OnlyFans moving away from adult content?
We did that already.
We did a whole episode on that.
Yep.
Accountability Party for Humans. SJ is one of the better guests y'all have had on the last few episodes. She got a mix of street, book, and sweet smarts. But other than that, Myron, I could tell you're going to lose hair tonight on this episode. That's a pretty good panel of ladies. And then Mary Knight. Oh, no, we're good. Maya, plug your stuff real quick. What's your website?
My website, guys, is www.slwjmc.net.net.
Shout out to her.
Cool.
Because you guys really liked her, so we brought her back. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, someone responded. Yeet or be yeeted, bitch. $20 says, you probably have one with that strong ass jawline.
Ooh.
He's talking to you.
Yeah, you got anything back for that?
Me? It's nicer than yours.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Okay. All right.
Okay. First question. So, ladies, what is the worst thing you've done to a man you dated? Chopped his balls off, told him that he sucks. Small the energy. What's the worst thing you did to a guy that you were dating? And we'll start here.
Oh, what? Why me? No. I declined the offer to be first because I don't want to be the toxic one.
It's an honor.
No. Yeah. Because we do it, the way we do it is it goes this way once and then we go that way. We switch it up every time. So you got to start with this one.
Okay, so one time my ex broke up with me and I took nickels and I scratched all his car. And I drew a dick on it with a nickel.
Oh, shit.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Damn. Talk about crazy. Okay.
Okay. Now I see why she didn't want to go first. All right.
All right.
Top that.
What did I do?
You forgot, huh?
It's been so many.
Yeah. Really. I just want to get the really bad one, but.
This one time at band camp.
For someone I dated, I think I would have to say, I don't know. I guess the worst thing, I probably went out with one of his friends.
Ooh. Okay.
Was it like your boyfriend or ex-boyfriend?
Ex-boyfriend, and I did it on purpose.
Oh, shit.
Did he find out?
Yeah.
Damn.
Now, here's the real question. I got to ask the tough questions.
Uh-oh.
Did he, like, cheat on you, and then you, like, said, all right, I'm going to get back at him?
Yes.
Okay.
He did.
And then was his friend like hitting on you the whole time you guys were in a relationship?
Not directly, but you could just tell.
Damn.
Yeah.
So what, he just shot a shot, or did you say, hey, let's go out?
He shot a shot.
And then you said yes.
Yeah.
Damn. Okay.
Sheesh. Okay.
Now I gotta ask the real one, the real question.
Oh.
Did he smash? Oh.
No.
Oh, damn.
Oh, man, you let him down. That was the highlight.
I used him.
You just used him to get back at your okay.
Well, she a finesser. She a tease.
Okay, fair enough. What about you, Maya?
This one time I gave this guy I was dating a verbal lashing. Look, the whole car ride.
What? A verbal?
Verbal lashing.
Oh, a verbal lashing. Okay.
Hey, look, the whole time, right? And then I look in the little mirror and his friend's in the backseat and I had no idea. And I felt like complete shit, honestly, because someone heard me say what I had to say.
Oh, so you told him what was up?
Yeah.
How'd you not know, though, when you were in the car?
I don't know. He was so fat, and I don't know. I think because he was so quiet about the things I was saying that I didn't think to look back. You know, I just got in the car.
Oh, you just, like, got in the car and didn't even realize someone was in the back.
Oh, and then I looked back.
She was laser focused. So when you got in the car, you already knew, like, I'm about to fucking.
Oh, yeah, I had prepped everything. Script was ready, yeah.
Oh, damn. Okay.
All right. Okay. I like that. So you just like shit on him, and then what happened with the friend in the back? Like, what made you realize?
I felt like such shit. I felt so bad. I felt really bad.
Because you emasculated him in front of his friend.
And not only that, made me think, oh, if someone could hear it, I probably shouldn't say. Like, if someone else would hear it and not like that, then I shouldn't say that shit ever. Like,
all right. Damn. Taking some accountability. All right.
There you go.
All right. All right. I like that. Okay.
Cool.
What about you?
So it was my mom's birthday, and I invited my ex and this guy that I was into to my mom's birthday. And the whole time my mom's friends were like, so who are you dating? I'm like, I don't know, it's a competition.
Talk closer into the mic.
Oh,
bring the mic closer to you, so they can hear you.
But yeah, do I say the whole thing again?
Yeah, say it again from the beginning. So the people, let's do a quick rewind.
All right. So it was my mom's birthday, and I invited my ex and somebody else I was feeling to my mom's birthday. And
what happened?
My mom's friends ended up asking me who I'm dating, whatever, and I ended up going out with one of them and left one of them at my house. So that was pretty terrible.
Oh, damn.
Shit. Ruthless.
Savage.
All right. Fair enough. What about you?
All right. Well, disclaimer, I don't condone violence, but.
Here we go. Hey, I don't condone violence, but.
But. Okay. I slapped my ex after he called me a bitch in front of his mom. And normally, like I said, I don't come to the wireless. I wish I took the higher road, but I just bought this man an $1,000 new Samsung Galaxy phone. And
stupid.
Exactly. I was like, if the roles were reversed, you would, like, I wouldn't act that way towards you. But anyways, that was the worst thing I ever did.
So what did he do? He like cheated or something?
No. Well, later on in the relationship, but at that time he was just upset that I was spending my money. He wanted me to spend my money on a car first instead of purchasing, because it's a long story, but he was trying to tell me what to do with my money. But I wanted the plan, two lines for $100, which is a good freaking deal, instead of one line for $70. So I'm like, I'm gonna get you a brand new phone, you don't have to pay for it.
Damn.
That's the thing, you don't have, I'm paying the bill. You understand? Like, you just give me your $50. I paid for the phone outright. You understand? So you just give me your half. That's it. You're already paying $50 a month for your little Metro.
Did you buy him grills? Did you buy him grills too?
No. I bought these myself, but he had grills. But I was like, what the fuck? I didn't understand it.
He was so ungrateful, huh?
Fair enough. Right?
That's dealing with insecure men. That's all that is.
Oh, okay.
What about you?
I'll be honest, I really don't have any exes. I just like get in relationships and like they end like 2 weeks later. But
what the fuck?
She honest.
There must be a reason.
I mean, like, okay, I'll tell you one reason. So like one of my very first relationships, like we hooked up for the first time and he was like a virgin and we just like weren't compatible. And so like 2 days later, I just broke up with him.
You smashed a virgin?
Yeah.
How was that?
I did too.
It wasn't like it wasn't bad. It just like we didn't like work together. We didn't like click. So we ended things and like moved on.
How's he supposed to know though?
I mean, I don't know, guys. Like it just like wasn't the right. I was in like late high school. Like he was about to go to college. Like it just wasn't the right time. But definitely that was probably the most toxic.
So, thing I've done. How old was he and how old were you at the time?
He was 18 and I was 17.
Well, yeah, don't get yourself jammed up. Okay, so you took his virginity. I will say this though, because we had girls on the podcast come and say, oh, it would be so cute for me to get a guy's virginity. And in my head, I'm like, bruh. Nah. Like, no girl wants to have to teach a guy how to do it. It's like,
honestly,
No.
I'm not gonna lie. I would like to train him.
You want to train him?
I would like to train him.
Right?
See, y'all say that.
I'll mold you to my liking.
No, you know, you experience.
Y'all say that, but in reality.
I haven't done it, so I'm just saying. I'm saying it would be a good experience to mold your little, you know, man.
He just told you.
We just have someone right here.
That's what you think is going to happen.
If it don't click, how you going to mold that?
They don't.
Like, it's you fun. Need that Puerto Rican sazon for a Puerto Rican.
Yes, mommy.
I was gonna bring that up.
Every girl wants to be that one that can do it.
I think it's like fun and theory.
I did it.
And how was it? Trash, right?
It was amazing. I'm not gonna lie.
Wait, taking a guy's virginity?
Yeah.
Okay, why are you? Are you with him now?
No.
Exactly.
There you go.
But it was fun. Son,
where'd you?
Huh? It was fun.
But you're not with him now, right?
No.
That's the whole point. Like, you might have done it just to, like, knock it off your bucket list, but it did not arouse you. You did not like it. Like, it was a cool experience, but, like, you ain't fuck
with
him no more.
It's a huge disappointment in the end.
It wasn't a disappointment.
Yeah. Yo, somebody said in the chat, I'm a virgin. Okay. We got it. Right,
so, okay. So, you took his virginity, and then you coasted him after.
Well, I mean, like, it wasn't just, like, that part of the relationship. Like, it was just, like, we were, like, why were we even dating? I don't know, but... That just kind of like was like the final straw, I guess. And after that, it was just no more for sure. But even before that, we were just like not good for each other.
We've talked about on this podcast, guys, women, if you take an average like young woman and an average young man, she's way more sexually experienced than average young man nowadays.
Yep.
Women 100%. Are out here getting way more bodies than dudes, man. It is what it is. So guys, get the experience so you don't get embarrassed. Don't be a fucking virgin, all right?
There you go.
What's your take on it? Go ahead. Okay. Worst thing you've ever done to a guy.
Oh, okay, so I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna answer this honestly.
Okay.
And if you're watching this, I'm sorry. Okay, so this was the most toxic relationship I've ever had. All right. Don't judge me. I don't condone none of this on either end.
Are we about to go down memory lane right now?
Oh, it's gonna get crazy.
Let's do it.
Hold on to your seats. All right.
Let's do it.
Ready. I got the hat ready if you're gonna
get it. I wanna hear this one.
Story time. Okay. So, I was living in Los Angeles with my ex. We're both from Florida. So it's like, you know, we were out there on our own. We were stuck with each other. Really toxic relationship. I don't recommend. Anyway, we were in a really heated argument and I'm just ignoring him. I'm on my tablet. I'm like, I'm not listening to you, tuning him out, blah, blah, blah. Toxic as fuck, throwing shit. All right. Oh, my bad. I'm not.
No, you go.
Okay.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay, cool.
You can say whatever.
So he gets mad. He splits my iPad in half, breaks it. I'm like, all right, bet. Go into my car and I'm out. So I'm just going to like take a drive, whatever. This man follows me to the car, acting all crazy and shit, yelling at me. I'm like, nah, I ain't doing it. No. So I turn on the car, right? And
I am one with the soundboard.
What did you do?
I'm one with
So look, I didn't run the man over, okay? No, okay? I didn't run him over. He jumped on the hood of the car, all right?
Okay.
And he was hitting my windshield, being crazy. So I floored it.
Oh, shit.
Damn. And he might have busted his ass, gotten some road burns and stuff. And so, like, we didn't last.
Wow.
Very long after that. I'm very honest.
Okay, LAPD, yeah, sorry, she's Chris. Here.
Okay.
Look.
Here's the address.
Yeah.
Pull up.
Hit and run.
I'm sorry.
No, that's funny. All right, what about you, worst thing you ever done with a guy?
I don't want to say it's a guy. I want to say it's a girl, a little gal.
Are you bisexual?
I am bisexual.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you prefer men or women, though?
I don't have a preference. That's not bisexual.
Ooh.
That's not bisexual.
But typically a girl
that's
like
not
has
bisexual. That's not bisexual.
You can be bisexual.
I mean, life. I don't have a preference.
You can like both
I'm
be
the bisexual.
Bisexual
that doesn't have a preference.
So you're 50-50, you like both the same.
What about animals?
What?
That's the animal or something like that.
So you like men and women the exact same. Okay, fair enough.
But I would say generally, like just, I can be a tease. Like so listen.
Translation, she could be a time waster.
I'm a duck. Like, I used to be a duck. Like, a bitch that never got no play, never nothing at all. Listen, nothing. Zero. Dry. Like, nothing. But, like, I don't know. As time went, you know, I can be very empathetic to people that don't get chances at all. because I used to never get a chance. So when I finally like was able to give people chances, I'd give people chances that I wasn't necessarily into. Totally.
Can you tell us a story, please?
What are you saying?
Damn.
You forgot your point?
It's a no, because it's a habit. Like, it's a bad habit. Like, I would feel like, so I
shirts
would not,
and stores.
I would not say it's just one person. Like,
okay. Tell us the best one. The worst story.
You got 20 seconds.
Yeah.
So are you a flirt? Because
I'm kind of a flirt. I've been a flirt in the past, but so habits 15. Are bad.
So what's the worst thing that you did to a guy or a girl?
Tease them to the point of loving me so much that they cannot have me.
Oh, damn. So you play with their emotions in their heart.
It's possible, yes.
Okay. It's pretty savage.
It's savage. It's a bad thing.
She didn't give a story, though. So I don't...
Because there's too many stories, sir. Like, there's too many
stories. Okay, we're just going to move on. Go ahead, your go.
Listen, I did a lot of things to that man. There's not even one that I could say. I done tried to run him over, tried to stab him, kicked him in his nuts to where he dropped down to the floor. Mm-hmm. Like, there's so much shit that I've done to this man that there's not even one thing. And I own up to it. I don't care. I've been arrested because I fucking put my hands on him.
Oh, shit, she cray cray.
He pushed me to that point.
Push it to the limit.
Okay.
Holy shit. Okay.
She playing that song after she chasing with him with a knife.
No.
You led me this way.
No. It's the actions that led up to that.
Okay. Wait. What did he do? I gotta know what he did.
And when men are like really like manipulated, they gaslight you a lot, like you go crazy. You like blind. Like, honestly, I'm not the type of person to go up to and scratch my ex's car or like leave him outside waiting like 5 hours just because I'm mad. I don't do that. But that person just brings out the little demon in me.
So
it's the fact of the matter that y'all fail to realize what pushes females to that point.
Here's what I'm taking from this. Rap bones are crazy.
Yeah.
I don't know, because I'm kind of crazy and I'm not a red bone, so what's up with that?
Like, yeah, you are kind of crazy. Okay.
Barnes.
Okay, so Super Chats and then the video we have. So Roy Barnes, $25. I don't understand this whole dilemma of 9-to-5 man being broke. I'm 32 male, and I've been investing in S&P 500 since I was 22. When I graduated college, making 60K, and now my portfolio is over 500K. I am in the 1% for my age. Oh, props to you, man.
All right, man. Congrats. Tech Julian, $50. Keep up the good work, Fresh and Fit. Shout out to Chris. Is the back for equipment management. Smasher pass. Okay, and then Tech Julian. All right, cool.
Add him to the list.
We got that one saved.
All right, guys, we got a video to react to.
We got a poll.
Okay, on Twitch. Okay, shout out to Twitch, by the way. We're doing a poll. Is the cap strong with this panel?
51.
98% said yes.
Only 1%.
To be honest, like I think that. I think they're telling the truth, which has me actually kind of concerned for my safety at this point.
For real.
But I want to see my mugshot.
Yo, real talk.
I never went to jail, so I don't have proof type shit. Yo, but I mean, okay.
You might get kicked in the nuts or something like from Manscaped. So shout out to them.
Shout out to them. Okay, we're gonna react to a video here, guys. So play the video.
Yeah,
okay,
video first.
Trey, can you give the background on this a little bit? Because you actually selected the shout out to Trey, by the way, our YouTube strategist.
Shout out to also
our audio engineer and YouTube strategist.
The baby as well.
Okay.
It's the first link.
Okay. Yeah, Trey, can you give them a background on this video or Fresh, one of you two?
So this is from the Baby the Rapper's Instagram page.
Okay.
He put out like a promo for his new music video.
Okay.
And it kind of highlights like what girls will do when they're put in a corner, so to speak.
Okay.
It's just pretty funny to see what they've done.
Let's let's get the video up. Chris is pulling it up right now. Can you enlarge that real quick, Chris?
Yeah, sure.
The baby says, "These motherfuckers are cutthroat." Mm-hmm. A laughing emoji. New single video tomorrow. And
slow down. All right, so let's play it.
And we having a roundtable discussion on how we made a fuck nigga cry. Me and a nigga was together for 2 years, and then he cheated on me.
Fair use.
I thought he loved me, so I got that nigga robbed at his job.
I ran that nigga dog over.
Yo, she would die, bro.
I ain't kill it, though.
Bitch-ass nigga was a nerd, so I wiped my ass with his homework. And guess what? A bitch had corn that day, too.
I fucked his friend and his brother.
Yeah! Lame-ass nigga was the sneakerhead. I took all the laces out that nigga's shoes.
Yo, she would die, bro.
Is that you, Hannah?
That's fucked up.
Oh, that's you right there.
That's you right
there.
I see you right there.
Oh,
that's you.
Oh, shit.
Wow.
Oh,
God, the boy, red bones with braids.
Oh, Lord.
Niggas thought they was gonna play with me.
Bernice. Mm-hmm.
Y'all know niggas love their grandma. And guess what I did? Push her hunchback ass down. Oh, I'm not the one to play with. Play with your granny.
It's about time that you niggas understand.
It's not Graham, Graham.
No,
that women rule the motherfucking world. And that's how we gonna always make you bitch niggas cry. Make the niggas
cry, put it in. Okay, so ladies.
Horrible song.
What is your opinion on this video? Is it good? Is it bad?
We'll go back this way.
So we'll go this way.
All right, the laces. I would have creased them shits. Fuck taking off the laces.
Oh, shit.
But the grandma shit was a little too much. You did too much on that one.
That's OD, huh?
Too much.
Damn.
All right, so don't push grandmas. I guess that's where you take the cake. Stabbing them, no big deal, but pushing a grandma, too far.
Okay, my opinion. Damn, what would I think about that? I mean, like, part of me feels like, damn, that's life. Like, you know, what y'all niggas do? Like, that's part of me. But the other half is like, you know, it's toxic. Like, there's traits in me that I'm trying to fix myself. So, of course, I have an opinion that might repel those things.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, I'm confused.
You was asking if I like the video or not. Part of me likes the video. Part of me does not.
Okay.
Part of me thinks, okay, some of those things is just life. And then part of me thinks that, damn, that shit is toxic because I've been a toxic bitch before. So I can't really condone those things.
Okay.
Boom.
So half and half.
Okay.
Half and half.
Okay. That's fair.
Your take?
I would never do that to shoes. I would never do the toxic shit again either. I would just leave, to be honest. Fuck that shit. I don't got time. Been there, done that. I need to make money.
Fair enough. Running people over, she's changed her ways.
100%, y'all. 100%.
I don't, like, my opinion on the video, like, I don't know how much of it was true. I thought it was funny watching it. I personally would never do any of those things, but I don't know, to each their own, I guess.
Okay.
Nah, I don't agree with any of it. None of it. It's all toxic behavior. I say keep it classy. Keep it just a little bit.
What? I thought girls like toxic, though.
No, not to the guy, like creasing the shoes and pushing over grandmas and shit. No.
Listen, if he cheats, he get his shoe crease.
No. It's better. He ain't died. I think you should just keep your power and just keep him walk it. That's it.
Okay.
Honestly, I mean, I'm not going to say never. I don't think I would do any of that. But I feel like sometimes I can get pushed to the limit where I'll do something like, I'll crease your shoes. I'll take your laces.
I feel like you beat somebody up, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm ready to go.
I can see that happening. All right.
I don't agree with the things they said. I would just say what the hell I got to say and I'm out.
Okay. No energy.
She'll just come in and yell at you in the car.
Zoom.
And then be out.
Classy, never trashy.
I would not scoop down to that level, though I have hit a man. I have. I'm not gonna deny that.
Punch them like full on fists and you, like, slap them.
I slapped him. I walked in and there was two girls in my apartment.
Oh, so damn.
I slapped the shit out of him.
In front of the girls?
In front of the girls.
And
I pulled them bitches out of my apartment.
Was he like, were they like his friends though? Or was he like trying to do a threesome or something?
Well, they're not his friends, but I don't know what his intentions were. I really didn't.
Were they naked?
No, they weren't naked.
You could have been friend zone with them.
No, I don't give a fuck. That's my apartment.
And they could leave.
You need to go fucking
leave. Oh, it was your apartment.
Yeah. Well, it was ours. It was a marriage. I was married. Nah, you ain't got no girlfriend. Nah, I slapped the shit.
Wait, it could have been his cousins, though.
No, I know his cousins. Don't play with me.
Okay.
But yeah, I wouldn't scoop down to that level.
All right, fair enough.
Okay, no grandma pushing. And basically, I'm not toxic, and I was toxic, so I'm trying to change. I don't condone it, but you got to do what you got to do sometimes. That's all I have to say.
Say it louder.
Okay.
So I don't stab people, but you should stab people every now and then.
If you come up to me.
I mean, if they put their hands on you, you can stab them.
Okay. Right. Did he put his hands on you?
Yes, he did.
He
broke my arm, gave me a concussion. The list goes on and on. So I had a right to do what I did.
Oh, wait, damn.
He hit me first. Oh, I wasn't having it.
Oh,
I can tell she wasn't.
She ain't playing with niggas.
That's why.
Yo, she ain't playing with niggas, bro.
I'm not just freely toxic. Like, ooh, I like to be toxic. No.
Exactly. Like,
but if you push me to that point, I'm going to show you.
Push it to the limit.
Push it to the limit.
To the limit.
God damn. Okay.
Very abusive.
Okay. Super chats. We got 15 up or 20 and up?
20 and up.
All right. Cool. Accountability for humans. Next show, definitely need a live therapist on for these ladies. Use cause, goddamn. Cody Lexer, $25.
I got issues.
Abstress Elementary Understanding Karma will catch up to you. Okay. $20. King Trevon. Damn, curly head drawing on cars. Corn roast stab, folks. and then Nolan Baptiste, $20. Super sticker. Thank you so much. The agency in New York City. Fresh a pick. Can you ask the ladies, what was the fastest a man did a money shot on their face?
Oh, you're funny, bro.
Okay. That's strange. Yeah. Anyway.
What is that?
What's the fastest dude busting nut on your face?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Max Baron Dees, new member. Thank you so much. And then, okay, cool. Next topic or next question or what?
Next topic.
Or should we let the ladies open it up to ask us a question?
After this one.
All right, let's do it.
Cool. So we got another video kind of highlighting the same type of like genre here. So, actually, no, it's a post actually on Instagram. So it's when you pulled up first, Chris.
All right.
So yeah. Honestly, the next topic is gonna be like things that girls did to men.
Okay.
So yeah. So ladies, what's the most effed up thing you did to a man? Pretty much the same thing, but this is their responses on Instagram. So we'll go through them real quick. So this girl said, mutt bitch, which thought was a messed up name. I didn't drive in high school, so I sucked dick for a ride to my boyfriend's house. And then they played the game together when we got there.
Oh, shit.
Nah, you foul. No. You okay. So foul for that.
Okay.
Nah.
Oh, no.
I will say this, though.
It says mutt bitch on there. Like,
mutt bitch with thought.
I want to know this. I'm going to ask the ladies real quick around the table because I was wondering if anyone did this.
That's wild.
Have any of you ever fucked a guy and then went back home to your boyfriend right after?
Never.
No. I've never cheated. And
wait.
I don't cheat.
What about blowjobs?
No.
You ever did a blowjob and then went home to your man?
No.
What about cream pies?
What if I gotta kiss this dude, bro? Like,
yo, because we know girls that have been cream pies.
See, I've been cheated on, so I don't do that to other people because, like, I'm actually genuine at heart. Like, I don't like to hurt people, but if you hurt me, I'm gonna hurt you.
Oh yeah,
but I'm not gonna voluntarily hurt you because that's just flaw. I'm not like that.
Yeah, you're not playing, so hey, yo.
Okay, big homie Parker fresh finna shit himself. Every time Shawty mentioned being arrested, he screams.
Yeah, I'm like,
yo, oh man,
oh lord,
can't make this up.
Okay,
right,
ladies, real quick. So, from that post, what are your thoughts on that? Hang on, RL, $20 first live show to effing it. Shout out to the whole crew, honor paying the dues, greeting ladies to Pinky Top. Aita Sakafet.
Hey,
Aita Sakafet, my dude.
Is that French?
That's a Creole.
Creole.
Oh, Creole. Okay.
You're from Haiti, right?
Bobo.
Yeah. So
oh shit. Okay. Haiti. All right.
So no. Real quick, let's do it one by one. So
I mean, it's more.
I know, but we'll do one by one.
All right.
So, ladies, what are your thoughts on this? Yes. No. Messed up.
No, that's messed up. You don't do that. Like, that's just. The fuck is wrong with you?
Okay.
I'm scared for you.
Get help.
Negative. That's messed up.
Yeah. I wouldn't do that. No, I would be scared. I wouldn't do that.
Okay.
It's fucked up, but it happens more than you think.
Okay.
I actually feel bad for her. You do, to be honest. She seems like she has to be pretty empty to be able to do that back to back, you know? Like, you really don't give a shit about yourself.
Why didn't your boyfriend give you a ride? That's the question.
Yeah, right? If you need to do that, just don't be in a relationship at all. It's just easier.
You're single. Okay, cool. Next right, one.
Fair enough. So, guys, stabbing and running you over isn't that bad, but hey, I ain't gonna suck no other dick. Let's continue on. Next one.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Right now, one second.
All right, guys, we're going to show you the next one on here and get a reaction to it. Yeah, the chat is hilarious. Okay. This comes from Virgo.
Mommy
made him get a vasectomy because I refused to be on birth control, then left him months later.
Oh, no.
God damn.
That's
That's creepy.
Okay, what are your thoughts on that?
That's just straight up dark, to be honest. Like, you got some demons that you're fighting if you're going to do that. I mean, that's just wrong.
Damn, that's savage.
All right, well, he could fix it. Just know you could just go back and fix it.
Yes.
And I would only have that for my husband because, yeah, birth control is shit.
Agreed.
Hey, man, just pull up.
Yeah, I was gonna say that. Yeah. Pull out, swallow by a pill.
Pull out game strong.
Yeah. Or kill.
I mean, personally,
I'm talking to Mike, into the mic, into the mic.
I'm not on birth control and I wouldn't want to be on birth control. And if somebody wants to stop doing whatever they're doing to not have kids with me, then they need to do whatever they need to do. That's I mean, I'm not good.
So you like it raw?
Yeah.
Okay, keeping it real. Keeping it real.
No, shout out to Haiti.
Yo, shout out to Haiti, man. Keeping it 100.
Stop, I say.
But no, I mean, I gotta
speak
know
to the mic.
There has to be certain
parameters, man.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I mean, I wouldn't leave the man if he got a vasectomy for me.
Okay.
So that actually almost happened to my dad. Some woman proposed that nonsense to him. He's as though, you know, they like to a little bit of a womanizer here and there. But no, I would never, ever, ever say that to a man to have someone do that. Because you're taking away their right. If you're not going to stay with them, you never know what's going to happen.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I agree. I think it depends on, like, the longevity of the relationship. If you think it's going to last years and years and, like, that's an option you want, you guys can talk about it, whatever. You're free to do whatever you want, but I think if there's a chance the relationship's gonna end like that, why go make a man have like a procedure like that? I don't know. I personally wouldn't do that.
Okay.
I would never tell my man to do that. It's the pull-out method until we die.
Okay.
Okay.
I feel like the dick work, even if you have foreskin. So
that's my answer. I don't feel like a vasectomy is necessary.
Okay. Yeah, you are awesome.
Okay.
I like you. You're awesome.
All right.
Just pull out. It's that fucking simple.
Okay.
What about the pre-cum though?
Right.
The pre-cum.
It's just real.
Okay, but I got a question though.
Okay.
You said.
Oh shit. Here we go.
Why have a man go through that procedure? But like, what if an accident happens and then a woman has to go through the procedure and he has nothing to do with it?
Okay.
And that's like, you can't, I'm sorry, but I feel like you can't control that. I mean, yeah, you can, but like it can happen just spontaneously.
The thing is, like when pregnancy happens, there's like so many ways to prevent it. You have condoms, you have.
But when it happens, it happens.
Plan B.
Yeah, but you're going to make a man get a procedure just because there's a chance that you might get pregnant from another way.
I'm talking about if you're pregnant. If you're pregnant, you have to get an abortion, then that's a procedure.
Yeah, but I feel like that's a little that's like a different topic than a vasectomy, because if you're in a relationship with somebody, I'm not going to be like, hey, you need to get a vasectomy because I don't want the possibility of having an abortion. You know, there's so many other routes to, like, there's so many different routes to take before you end up having to get an abortion. You have plan B if something does happen, accidents happen, plan B. You can use condoms. You can use, I know some people are allergic to birth control and have really bad side effects. But
allergic.
Yeah. There's the U-ring. There's so many, there's like 20 plus contraceptives for women. So I get where you're going with
this. There's a lot of different ways to prevent something like that from happening. And I think that people should go down one of those routes before it ever has to get there, or before you have to make a man get a procedure that he might not even want. He might just be doing to make you happy.
All right, fellas. All right. So cream pie and get a plan B.
There you go.
There you go.
So this episode is sponsored by Plan B, as a matter of fact. Let's go ahead and hit us up. Send us an email. Freshofitpartnerships@gmail.com.
You want to?
Oh, well, we'll finish this real quick. Cool. All right. What's next here? I was first. You got this one.
Playboy Lex. So, she's saying, I was talking to a guy and I was messing with someone else. He texted me while I was messing with the other dude, and homeboy sent him a voice audio telling him how he just swallowed his kids and we're about to go around two. And to remember that the next time I kiss him. Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
Yo, that's ruthless. So she's with a guy. The guy that she's messing with hits her up. The guy that she's with sends a voice note saying, hey, she just swallowed my kids and you better kiss her next time.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
Wild.
Ladies, what are your thoughts on
we'll
that?
We'll go with here first.
I don't even got no words on this one here. That's just some crazy shit right there.
It's a mouthful, huh? No pun intended. Literally.
Pun intended.
Okay.
What kind of life are you living? Like, I want to know. Like, how do you set that up? Like, I don't know. Like, I don't know how you set that up. Girl, don't do that.
Yikes. That's okay. Messy.
That's crazy.
That's literally asking for an ass beating.
That's too messy. That's
like
messy.
My mouth is open. That's so shocking to me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you gotta keep it open, you know.
Wow.
I think like if the guy that she's with sent that like without her knowing, I think that's kind of messed up. Maybe she should be mad at him. Mm-hmm. But if she sent that herself, like that's a little weird. Like I definitely wouldn't do that. But I don't know. Every relationship's different. Maybe he doesn't really care.
Yeah, if he sent that, that's
right.
That's like, a little bit of simp behavior to me. I'm like, why? But I guess he wants to one up an egotistical thing for him. But either way, I wouldn't be caught in that situation. That's nasty. I don't mess with two people at the same time.
All right, go ahead.
Okay. Honestly,
keep it real. Keep it real.
No, I'm gonna keep it so real.
Just talking
to
the mic.
The girl, if she knew that the guy was sending the voice note, she wanted to break up with her boyfriend. That's it.
That's what I'm about to say.
That's exactly. One. And then two, if she didn't know, why that other nigga got your phone anyways? Mm. My phone in my purse?
Right.
Period. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. If he was just snooping, that's a stupid. Okay. I'm going to make sure I'm the only nigga. I'll make sure.
Okay.
I'm going to be honest with y'all. I think that was whack. If you fucking someone and they got a nerve to, you know, go ahead and just do that to you and you guys didn't break up, you're a dumbass for sitting there cheating, and you're a dumbass for cheating with another dumbass.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
That's true.
I'm gonna have to agree a lot with the ladies. Why was he with your phone unless you did that on purpose? To be honest, we all know here that no one has our passwords. So if that voice note did get sent, you did want him to hear that. Mm-hmm. So that's on you and on him. That's pretty messed up.
I think it's mainly on her. Mouthful. Yeah. Mouthful.
Yeah, I agree with the girls. You know, you're kind of dirty, but, you know, everybody needs their dose of calcium, I guess.
Calcium.
I'm Puerto Rican. My first language is Spanish.
I see everyone's jokes are tonight. Yeah, I'll say this. Like, that's probably one of the biggest violations. The thing is, though, come on, ladies. Are you telling me that you've never had sex with another guy or done some sexual act to get back at your boyfriend?
Yo, I know so many girls like that. It's crazy, bro.
What about a guy that you're not dating?
Tell me what's
dating.
The point, though.
I'll tell you the point. Because women know deep down that men are very territorial. Mm-hmm. And the best way to get back at an ex-boyfriend and or ex-lover is to have sex with another man and record it and or let him see it, because men are very territorial with women.
Spiteful.
But let me add to that. I don't know, because my ex niggas did not give, sad to say, they did not give a fuck about me.
I can be territorial.
I could do whatever I wanted. They did not care.
I guarantee if you sent them a video of you sucking another dude's dick, they would feel some type of way.
It's
the same vice versa, though. Like, I'm very territorial. Like, if you're one of them niggas that want to be spiteful, you can easily send a picture of you doing whatever the hell
it's not the same.
How is it not the same? Because if you send something to me, I'm going to be like, what? Like,
it's not the same.
It's
going
to be to the heart.
No,
yeah,
it's not the same. But sorry, does somebody have something?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, for example, I wasn't dating this dude, but like we weren't together, but we were like kind of talking and like riding together and shit.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah.
So, yeah, he had gotten into a situation where he linked up with some celebrities looking for stuff, and they ended up in a yacht. You know, he had a threesome, whatever. I'm like, oh yeah, you lit. All right. You know what I did? I also hooked up with a little celebrity that came into town, and I show him the video. I was like, oh yeah, I was lit too, bitch. Receipts.
Who was it?
I'm not saying.
Okay. Don't expose yourself, girl.
No. I ain't name dropping. You know who he is.
It's so close.
I feel like you have a relationship where it gets to that point where you guys are just like doing each other dirty like that. Like maybe it's just not the right relationship.
Oh no, it's nothing serious.
Just be single.
Okay. Anything else?
Yeah. I want to go back to the men being territorial. To be honest, they are. Like, when you get married, that's his last name. It's not yours. Like, it's just, they just are because they are. There's nothing else I can say. That's just their nature.
Straight facts, man.
And to add to your question, you said, you know, have you ever gotten back to anybody? Yeah. The thing about that is, while you're getting back, you lose respect as a woman. Like, why would I get back at you when you're a man and you could sleep with so many girls and this and that? If I do that, I'm dirtying myself. No, if I do that, I'm losing respect for who I am. I'm losing value as a woman. Mm-hmm. Why would I even get no? Like, you just lost me for doing the stupid shit you did.
Can I ask you guys something? Can I ask both of you something?
Sure.
If your girl, well, you're, okay, yeah, you guys.
Talking to Mike, please.
Sorry. Okay, you guys are having issues or whatever, and then she sends you a video of her fucking somebody else. You would take her back?
No.
No.
Do you know who you're talking to? Do you know who you're talking to?
Nah, but.
Stone Cold Stunner.
I'm trying to understand what you said, because you said it's going to get you jealous.
Fresh, you want to take it first, and then I'll give my little take on this.
So I'll tell you this, right? Mm-hmm. I've been on the other end where I did the cream pieing. You feel me? Mm-hmm. I did the bust in the face, and she had a dude. I didn't even know. And she went home to dude, and I was like, bro, you got a man? but like, I can understand that, like, okay, if the guy doesn't know, he doesn't know. But my thing is, like, if you're doing that action, it's like, yo, why are you able to do it in the first place? Because now you got, like, yo, okay, get this, right? The girl got a cream pie, bro. Went home to do it, and he ate her out.
Ew.
Like, what the fuck?
That's just rest in peace.
But look, that shit happens, though. That shit happens, though. But I would just say, if it's my, look, first of all, right, like, I don't have a girl. Ew. But if it was my girl that did that, that's like, ew. I need, yo. Real talk, take a shower.
That's foul. That's
but like,
foul.
How would you know though? Unless you like inspected it before you even got
a cream pie.
That's weird to me though.
You would know.
No.
Don't sure you know.
Bro, Dick has would know
that a man that knows his female is going to know.
Because look, there's a smell that you know your girl Dick has. So when someone's been in there, it's like, yo, this thing smells kind of like a different smell. So real talk.
Yeah.
Honestly, speaking of smell and hygiene. Should we?
Yeah, go ahead. Let's do it.
All right, guys.
Guys, you can't be a dirty motherfucker. And this video is brought to you by our sponsor over at Manscaped, okay? Your balls will thank you.
And so, guys, speaking of hygiene and being clean, you know, by your penis area and your vagina area, you want to make sure you're always smelling clean and fresh and always shaved, because trust me when I say, they will inspect you.
Absolutely.
So, guys, we've got a number of products here from Manscaped. We have the foot duster, refined cologne, the plow, crop cleanser, and crop mop, right? So, guys, real talk, right? You don't want to be out here being bushy like you're in a forest, because obviously she might get lost in the forest.
Yeah, you don't want to be
tall. So you want to trim without breaking your balls or cutting yourself. So get the Weedy Whacker. It's actually it's electronic. It's very stable, and also as well, you can't get cut. And you can also charge it wirelessly as well if you're in the house. So, and also, guys, regarding the Manscaped products, real talk, when I say this is one of the best products you can use for cleaning down below and at top, because you guys are sometimes dirty because you use the same razor for your balls, for your face. They have two different products, one for your face, one for your balls. And just when I say, girls love when you smell good and when you are clean shaven for the most part, right? So hygiene is very important, right, ladies?
And most importantly, guys, as skin-safe technology, guys, as skin-safe technology, which will keep you from nicking yourself and cutting yourself and fucking yourself up, because as we all know, one of the worst things that can ever happen is you're shaving your balls and you nick yourself, and then you got to put a band-aid on, or you get bumps, and then the chick is like, oh, what the?
Nope.
And she ain't going to want to mess with you no more. She's going to think you got that stit or that HIV. So with that said, guys, keep yourself nice and shaved. Keep yourself looking presentable. And at the end of the day, guys, most women, if you ask them on a balance of probabilities, hey, do you prefer clean shaven or not? They're going to want it at least trimmed to some degree.
Guys, there's a link you can use. So go to manscaped.com, type in the code Fresh and Fit whenever you go to buy. You get 20% off and free shipping.
Yeah. So guys, I said that myself earlier, guys. Right when I was showering before this. So
you got the
I'm smooth
trimmer here, Manscaped trimmer here. You have the spray for your ball toner survivor. And then also the deodorant as well. So before you go have your girl go down there, spray this like an
yeah,
hour before.
Guys, like do not smell clean. Yeah, bro, guys. You and guys gotta be clean, man. Wash your ass.
Wash your asshole, bro. Yeah, real talk, man.
That lotion has a pH balance to help your balls smell good. You know, so
I guarantee you guys, every girl at this table, I won't even ask, have probably dealt with some kind of guy that smelled right before or after intercourse, or they didn't want to do it anymore because the guy was stinky. So get yourself clean, shave yourself, keep yourself landscaped.
Bam. And guys,
or manscaped.
We've heard stories of guys hurting themselves in the shower, shaving with regular products. And they had a date and it ruined the whole day. So once again, guys, these products do not ever cut you. They're electronic, and at the same time, they're very high quality. So guys, keep it simple, keep it to the point. Get Manscaped, support us, code Fresh and Fit,
And yeah, guys, enjoy.
Manscaped.com. Use and use the code FRESHANDFIT for 20% off, guys.
Your balls will thank you, and also your girl. There you go.
So, all right, cool. Let's hit some of these super chats, and I'm going to tackle this concept of a woman cheating on a guy versus a man cheating on a guy real quick and transitioning back to the show. All right. Big homie Parker, $25. Fresh Finna himself. Oh, no. Read that one.
Yeah.
RL, first live show to FNF.
No.
Okay. $20. Cole Kanth. How many IG followers does a guy need to seem normal? I got 500, by the way, a stock tip. Polygamy plus polygyny is an egg freezing and fertility benefits company growing fast and up 50% this year. Bro, oh, that makes sense. Yeah, more
you need the course, my friend. 500 is too low. Okay, ladies, question for you guys. If a guy has 500 followers, what are your thoughts right off the bat?
That's not bad. Oh, sorry.
I mean, it's not bad. I guess like the less followers he has, it's like more like mysterious, you know, but if you got a little clout, it's okay. But just not that much because I get jealous. I'm toxic.
Okay. That made perfect sense.
Okay.
That made perfect sense.
I really care. It depends on the like how he looks and what he has on his Instagram.
Guys, take notes. Listen to what they say right now. And then we're going to show you guys later on when we do the Smasher Pass.
If I met you in person, it don't matter. If I see you online, it matters.
Awesome. Okay.
Yeah, just like she said, I feel like if I see you online, I feel like...
Merch.
Shirts and stores.
Huh?
Oh, no, we have t-shirts that say, I feel like, right here. Guys, I feel like t-shirts in stores.
There you go.
Go ahead.
But yeah, I feel like if I meet you online, it's different. But if I meet you in person, I mean, I really couldn't give a shit.
Awesome. Real quick.
Yeah, same thing. If I meet you online, it matters. It gives me, like, honestly, sometimes you think it's a good thing that guys are not on social media because it's less of a stress. Mm-hmm. But it's like everybody has one. Sometimes you find yourself thinking, if you don't have one, what are you? You're weird.
It's kind of weird, right? Mm-hmm.
But 500 followers, it doesn't bother me. It just says you're not really into it. So that's better for me.
Okay. You?
I think like the only like weird following thing on Instagram is like if you follow 2,000 people, but you have zero followers, that's like kind of a flag, but I don't really care otherwise. That's
okay.
But, so I guess I kind of have a little different perspective. So I'm an artist, so I need like someone who's going to be able to handle numbers. So if I see that you got numbers on your Instagram, that means you moving, you doing stuff, you networking, you probably, you know, have your own shit going on. So I know you could handle like what comes with my type of lifestyle as well. Studios, video shoots, everything that comes with like, you know, you have to be able to handle that. And I've dated men who would be great, wonderful husbands who have 200 followers, but they can't handle the lifestyle that I'm trying to live.
Mm.
So it's like, it's weird. It's a weird reason, but it's like, I have my reason.
We get it. Okay.
I'd have to say that I really don't care about your social media. I'm somebody that really cares about who you are. Like, I just, period. Like, the end.
Okay. There you go.
Listen, if I can match your energy, we match energy, we vibe, we connect. All right, we cool, we chilling. If I meet you on Instagram, 9 times out of 10, the men that I meet on Instagram, I feel like they're weirdos and they're creeps. So I don't even talk to them. I don't even answer them. I don't give them the time of day. But if I meet you in person and I actually can bond with you and vibe with you and fuck with you, all right, yeah. You got like, what, 500 followers? All right, that's cool. I don't care.
Guys,
because I met you in person.
Remember these answers?
Yeah, and then watch when you see the Smasher Pass
and
later on.
And also,
the discrepancy.
In the course, we tell you that's exactly how many followers you need to bypass certain requirements that women have. So
all right. Nasty Power Games to control dating. And these are the games to make him chase and invest while she becomes the relationship prize. Okay. That's from Will I Ruin Her. That's why you never, ever date a ratchet 304 unless, regardless of their race, and never date a chick who outweighs you. Okay. I think that was responding to the videos from before with the fat chick that pushed the grandma. GMAC, $20. Toaster strudel, her no Twinkies, fellas. Okay.
Agreed.
20 hours. Spencer, 30-year-old engineer, making 6 figs, good shape. I've been unplugging the past 2 hours. Myron, you teaching has helped solidify the masculine presence I knew I always had. You have shifted my mindset. I am the prize, do the work. Yep,
awesome.
Absolutely. And then GSXR MIA, whoever placed curly hair next to Myron is really testing his commitment to the movement tonight. okay. I don't know what he means by that, but Minor Gonzalez. Can someone tell this girl what a vasectomy is? The DIC works even with the foreskin. This girl talking about circumcision,
oh,
stupid.
No.
He's clowning you.
Oh, no.
Circumcision, vasectomy is the same motherfucking boat to me. If you doing any snip, snip, snap, snap, you ain't got to do it.
You feel me?
They're
period.
Far different. But
you
okay.
Get now?
But okay, Crank Trevon, curly hair can get it only if she keep her artwork off my whip. Okay.
Oh shit. Crank there Trevon. You go.
Brennan Tomasco, keeping it real. Blonde girl in the back is the move tonight. Okay.
Okay,
and
there you go.
On, about, 50 and up.
Yeah, from here, 50 and up, 50 guys, because we already got almost 6,000 live viewers. Thank nice. You guys so much. Make sure to
like the video
because
sub to the channel.
Yeah, we need the
guys
need the help with the algorithm.
We're almost at 300k. Help us get there. So if you're not sub to the channel right now, go ahead down below, sub to the channel, support us.
And I'm not going to go on a rant with this, but going back to what we're talking about, the girl that sucked the guy off and then went in to hang out and he, like, you know, left a voicemail, whatever.
That's a no.
A lot of girls here pretty much echoed what I said. It's not the same when a woman gets back at a man sexually versus when a man gets back at a woman sexually. When a man gets back at a woman sexually, he had to earn that ability to do that. It's not easy for men to get sex, but when a woman gets back at a man sexually, she just lowered her value because it's easy for her to get sex.
Yep.
So that's why it's not the same. And if anything, you look like a bigger hoe by doing that, yes. And you just make yourself less attractive by smashing another dude.
Well, there's no
He'll
point.
Get mad. He will get mad, but more than likely, he ain't going to want to fuck with you ever again, and he'll never take you serious.
There's no point in doing that when women are already known for being for the streets.
Yep.
So if you do that, you're just proving their facts.
There you go.
There you go.
Accusations even more. So there you go. There's no point in doing that.
Yeah. Like, and what'll happen is, because somebody said, hey, will you take a girl back if he cheats on you? Most guys... I'm not going to lie. Some suckers will take a girl back after they cheat on him.
Sheesh.
But he's always going to remember in the back of his mind, and he might not marry you or take you seriously. He'll just, like, he'll take you back, but he's going to, like, do other shit. So you had something?
Sometimes women are overly sexualized to begin with, in my opinion. So I feel like that's kind of where it begins, where women are held to a certain standard other than men. So... that's just my opinion.
I think it's all the damn.
But I feel like.
I mean, we don't sexualize men the way women are sexualized.
No,
like,
that's because, to be honest, if you look at a billboard, I don't want to see a penis on a billboard. I want to see tits, gay, straight, bisexual, whatever. That's because women have more of an opportunity to use their sexuality. So therefore, some indulge in it and over sexualized. And that's what the market
bam
opening.
You killed that
over indulge, definitely.
Well said.
That's the word.
Yeah. I mean, the reality is, like, you know, men and women are very different. So when you guys run around and, you know, are promiscuous, whatever, there's consequences to that. And the consequence is men are not going to respect you. Mm-hmm. So getting back at a guy, sending him a video of you smashing a girl is not going to hold the same weight as a man sending you a video of him smashing girls, because that man had to bring value to the marketplace to fuck girls in the first place. Whereas with women, you lost your value because a woman's job is to preserve value. A man's job is to create value.
Yep. Exactly.
So. But yeah, this is good. You guys are pretty based. That's
we
good.
Got some more okay. slides
yep.
for the post.
Yep.
No, we only have one more.
Also, oh, one more slide. All right, let's do it.
Future. That was it.
Oh, okay, cool.
Future. Shout out to Future.
All right. So there's one more reaction we have tonight.
All right.
And smash your pass, guys. So get your.
Oh, wait. We should turn it over to the ladies ask us a question.
We'll do it after this.
You sure? Okay. Yeah. All right. $1 million worth of jewelry from date while he slept. Oh, okay. Yeah. Someone set this up. Can you enlarge this, Chris?
Yeah, sure.
And, so this girl went on a date with this guy. I think there's more to the title, Chris.
Top. Scroll up, Chris. So this is from The Shade Room.
Police say Atlanta woman stole $1 million worth of jewelry from date while he slept. So this is a finesse on another level.
Yeah.
So
crazy.
All right.
Let's play the clip.
Look familiar. Over the weekend, Atlanta police say she swindled her date, starting with an opening glad to meet you conversation at a Roswell Road night spot. After some food, the two visited a Buckhead adult entertainment location.
Atlanta, man.
And the party went on to after midnight. The night did not end there. Last stop, a swank hotel. Now, here's another surveillance image, and check out what the...
pause
it.
You see,
he already fucked up.
Yo, iced out from the chain to the wrist to the holy smoke.
He's fat.
You made the bed.
Yeah. I guarantee you this dude was tricking. Stupid. This dude was at the strip club throwing money.
Yeah.
And all right, let's keep going.
She saw easy target.
Yep.
You see your face?
Behind the young lady is wearing lots. This woman looked familiar.
Brought his face, though.
Over the weekend, Atlanta police say she swindled her date.
You went back.
It's fine.
Okay, good.
An opening glad to meet you conversation at a Roswell Road night spot. After some food, the two visited a Buckhead adult entertainment location, and the party went on to after midnight. But the night did not end there. A swank hotel.
You need to go.
Now, here's another surveillance image, and check out what the date who's behind the young lady is wearing.
Seven chains on his neck.
This woman looked familiar. I guess that's it, bro. Atlanta police say she swindled her date.
All right, so pause it. So let's read the thing. It says, according to Atlanta Journal Constitution, the average date in Atlanta will run you about $120. But for one unfortunate man, his recent date ran him about $1 million. Atlanta police are looking for a young woman accused of running off with the man's jewels while he slept. Apparently, the two had just met and spent a few hours together before Lil Mama's alleged heist all went down. The man and woman enjoyed some food and a little adult entertainment at another spot before they wound up at the hotel sharing a bed together. Once they were inside the hotel room, the man stored his jewelry in the room safe. He eventually went to sleep, and when he woke up, the bathroom shower was running. He assumed his date was clicked the link. Oh, okay, that's the full story. But yeah, I guess she ran the shower thinking that he would think that she was still there. Smart. This chick's done this before.
Yeah, she's smart, and she ran off.
Yeah, and on top of that, she knew his safe.
What the hell?
Combination. Ladies, I guess we'll go around the table. Thoughts on this? Do you know a girl that's done this before to someone? You don't got to snitch her out, obviously. But we tell guys all the time you know what? I'll give my opinions at that.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Let's start with Miss Puerto Rico.
I mean, I don't like that sweeper, no swiping. You know, like don't be doing that because that's just wrong. You know, cute. Like don't be stealing people's stuff. But you know, that's just dark.
Swiper, no swiping.
Yeah, you know, like Dora the Explorer. You know, swiper, no swiping.
Oh. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
No, I do not know anyone that's done that. I think it's pretty dumb. Like, she should have not stole so much because, you know, they're going to find you. You should have just kept it low, like maybe here and there a little bit. Don't do the whole thing. It's $1 million. They're going to find you.
Yeah. Yo, someone said she ran. Enough. Call it Manscaped. Shout out to our sponsor, Manscaped. Hey.
Shout out.
Shout to them.
He just got played. That's
what Finesse game strong.
I know a guy that's happened to.
Mm.
He's like a pretty close friend of mine, but
was he like a musician or something, or did he just get like cash stolen?
He was just like a promoter.
What did he get stolen? Money or jewelry?
Jewelry and money, I think.
Damn.
I think. Yeah. Damn. But I mean, I would never do that personally.
I hope.
But that guy should have known what was coming for him because you got to be careful and shit like that.
Maya, do you know girls that have done that in the past?
All of them, yeah. I know a lot of them.
Damn.
Fair enough.
Maya's a real one.
Maya's a real one. She knows. What's up?
I'm not saying don't smash, but don't fall asleep, nigga. Just leave. Like, go home.
This is why a lot of guys will talk kick girls out after they have sex. Yep. That's a big reason why they do it.
Rappers do.
Rappers be doing that shit all the time.
You got to go home, sweetheart.
I think I would never steal from anyone. I don't know anyone who has. I think it's kind of classless, but I don't know. Desperate times call for desperate measures, I guess.
Okay.
Teach their own. I don't know.
Look, I know a lot of girls that did this. I used to work at a strip club as a waitress.
Yeah.
I would not personally do it. That's some broke bitch shit. But I think, you know, people do this every single day. The only reason she's on the news is because it was $1 million, like, worth of jewelry.
Yeah.
Like, this shit happens every day. It's like, that's an L. You did it. You stupid. You invited her over. You gave her access to your place. You're safe. Like, bro, you did it to yourself. Like,
but I don't really think it's his fault. Like, if I wear six watches on my arm, like, I'm not gonna think somebody's gonna come and like.
Okay, but did he know her? Did he know her though?
You don't take a stranger and sleep but like close your eyes. So you don't lay your head.
Yeah, I guess like.
Well, hold on, ladies. Don't just gang up on her. Where are you from? Where'd you grow up?
I grew up in Miami.
You grew up in Miami, like your entire life?
Yeah.
Like Miami, the city, or like up north?
Miami.
Okay. So then you should know that this is like crazy. Then I thought you were like from somewhere else.
People are saying that they drugged them.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
She drugged him with the same drugs that took out Prince.
That's what happened to my friend.
Free Pooh Shiesty, man. He's in jail right
Big
now.
Big purr.
So you see that all the time. Okay. And then,
you know, it's like people will steal jewelry, a watch, or like drugs or money or something that happens is really common. Just don't pick nobody up from the strip club. Like, what's wrong with you?
What, your take on
number one rule, Miami, don't do it.
Yeah.
Don't do it.
I've seen it before. And I just say that it's around the world, like around the globe. I'm from Colorado, so I don't know if that speaks for itself. I'm not necessarily from Miami, but people do what they do. Mm-hmm. They do how they do it, however they do it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, you really just got to be mindful. Watch out for who you really messing with. Like, in all actuality, y'all just let whoever into your world, into your little atmosphere, mm-hmm. and you get messed up in the end. So,
okay.
Cool.
Exactly. It's common sense. You can't be mad because you got fucked over because you
played stupid. Like, you made a dumbass move. You gotta.
But
like,
if she drugged him, that's not his fault.
Okay, if she
drugged
him
in the hotel, yeah, though. That's messed
up. Exactly. He brought her. She already had that in her head, but like, you brought her to your hotel room.
Yeah.
So like, at the end of the day, you still trusted somebody that you didn't know, so you did it to yourself.
Period. If you're wearing $1 million of jewelry, you have to leave the house knowing you're a target.
You did it to yourself. You made your bed, now lay in it. Like,
okay, yeah, so
trying to flex that hard, but then you get finessed.
I'll tell you this, because we talk about this, we you know, there's got to be accountability. The thing is this, I like that a lot of the ladies at the table said that this happens every day. Because we say on the podcast all the time, this does happen every day.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that it doesn't get reported because, yes, the amount was ridiculous. And on top of that, a lot of guys are scared to go to the police because let's say they're a drug dealer, whatever it is, they ain't going to go to cops and be like, oh, she stole my dope. She stole my watches or whatever. Yeah, or if they do illegal shit and they got their money doing legal shit, they can't go to the cops. Mm-hmm. And the other reason, too, is because a lot of guys don't want to get embarrassed to go to the detectives. Yeah, this chick, you know, she robbed me. They're going to look at him like stupid and they're going to laugh and they're like, not going to take the case seriously. You know what I'm saying? Let's keep it a stack. Police departments are not going to take the same urgency of investigating a theft and or robbery where there's a male victim and a female perpetrator versus the other way around. It is what it is. It's a double standard in life that exists. Mm-hmm. And a lot of guys don't want to feel stupid. So they just hold the L. So and then, you know, like we said before, if it's a street dude, he definitely ain't going to go to cops. He's just going to hold the L. So, guys, just know that if you have something of worth, women are going to look at you as a target and they're going to rob you. And it happens way more than you think. They just took down a ring of girls that were doing this shit in the Midwest. And you can't be stupid, man. You got to think with this head and not that head down there. If you have a lot of things that are worth something and you don't know this girl like that, kick her out your spot after, bro.
Now, I'll say this, right? I got a different opinion. So if this nigga had insurance on his jewelry, he just made a whole lick for himself. Because think about this, right? You buy jewelry at a jewelry store, whatever, is appraised for a certain amount, but you might buy it for less. So if his jewelry was appraised for way more and this happened to him, he's getting a bunch of money right now from insurance. Mm-hmm. So hopefully he's insured with
his jewelry. But this is a street dude, bro, more than likely. Just by that amount, he ain't getting no insurance on that shit. He's going to be like, if nigga try me, you going to die. You know what I'm saying? You know how dudes are, bro. Yeah. They're not going to get no insurance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They're going to look at it like,
they don't need insurance because they could just go buy it again. Yeah.
I need security. I got my own fire in the club. Like, shit like that, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so,
okay.
I don't know if we just want more.
Culture Cat. Hey, guys. My husband and I are watching together and want to know from everyone what qualities they think make a woman a good wife, and are these qualities the same across the board?
That's not today's topic, though.
Interesting. Yeah, it's not today's topic, though. But, hey, I'm glad that you're watching it with your husband. We do get a lot of, you know, couples watching the show.
Yeah.
And it's great because we get a lot of, you know, really heartfelt messages saying, hey, you saved my marriage. Hey, I didn't realize that I need to do this to keep a man around, whatever it may be. Mm-hmm. Kept a lot of girls from being single with Cat Lady. So it's great, man, because we keep it real with you guys.
So ladies, now it's your turn to ask this question.
Yes, you guys can go.
Regarding dating, lifestyle, whatever you want. So we'll start.
I went last. She can go first.
Oh, yeah, she went. Wait, hold on.
Oh, I think.
Oh, you got some already?
I got a question.
Yeah, sure.
I'm not saying that you guys got cheated on or you aware that someone's lying to you. But what is that itch that you feel when you know a bitch lying?
Sorry, say that one more time.
What is that itch that you feel? Describe it, and how can you tell she's capping when she's capping?
Okay, so you mean like, what's the feeling you can tell when a girl's like playing a fool?
Like, girl, I know you finna play me. Like, what is the obvious? What is the giveaway signs that are obvious?
It's good. That's actually a really fucking good question.
I would say like, I always watch somebody. Like, I'm very quiet. I don't really talk a lot. I let them do the talking, and sometimes like she'll lie to her mom on the phone. Like, oh, I'm over here, but you know, I was over here. Blah blah blah. And I'm like, if you're lying to your mom, he will lie to me too. That's one thing. And then, for example, let's say I'm up with a girl, right? And like, she has like something to do, like with work, whatever. And she skips work for me. I'm like, that's your job. You're skipping work for me. It's kind of, so certain things that she does with me, I'm like, you know what? I can't really trust her. And then added to that, let's say like her personality is like the type where she will like be very spiteful for no reason. It's like, okay, if you're spiteful with those people, you can do it to me too. So I'm just thinking, okay, I'm gonna be quiet. You ask your questions, see who you really are, because you're gonna tell me who you are off rip without me even asking you fully. And I just watch people from that angle, but I never put myself in a situation where I can get hurt. So either way, I'm gonna be on guard at all times, but I can read people very well. So
I got a follow-up question. Or
go ahead.
I just wanna know. So let's say you, like you said, you figure that she's on everything you just said, she's on that. Mm. Do you just leave? You confront, then leave? Or you confront and you dismiss it and you try to figure it out.
You mean for long term?
I don't. The first time you see a bitch lying, do you just not say anything? Or you just be like, look, I know you capping, blah, 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 peace out.
Oh no, I don't say shit. Mm-hmm. So I'll know what she's on, but I'm gonna get what I want and then just dip.
Right.
Yeah.
Are we talking like sexually or like a relationship? Because there's two different avenues.
Both. Anytime you feel her lying sexually, you just lying to me on anything that you shouldn't lie about.
Well, I'll just go the sexuality route first because she's got to comply with that first before a relationship even starts. So I'll just go off the foundation. With me, it comes down to compliance. It's very easy to tell if a woman isn't interested in you as a man. And the reason why is because a lot of guys listen to what women say, but they don't watch what women do. Two different things. If a girl likes you, she's going to make concessions and she's going to be very compliant. You know, compliance pretty much shows attraction. So if you tell her, hey, let's do this, let's do that, and she doesn't argue or give you no bullshit or she does what you say, that's a good, you know, I always say, you know, reward good behavior, punish bad behavior. That's why we went viral on TikTok and kicked off. And with women, it comes down to her just like following compliance. And if she doesn't comply, then, you know, you obviously, you know, we teach guys, you know, you got to punish that to some degree, whether it's like you curve her or you make fun of her, whatever it is. But compliance is pretty much the main measuring tool to see if a girl actually likes you or if she's capping. Because if a girl doesn't like you and she's using you for like some ulterior motive, money or whatever it may be, it's going to be blatantly obvious when you try to escalate. You touch her, she's going to back away a little bit or she's going to feel uncomfortable. Because even though she might say something, her body language and her actions are going to show you otherwise. So what I need guys to do is like understand that you got to watch her very closely and see what she's doing, because what she says and what she's doing sometimes are going to be incongruent. And that's when you have, you know, the red flags, like some going on.
Guys, very important. Don't listen to what she says. Watch what she's doing.
Watch what she does, bro. Yep. Watch what she does. Like if a girl might say, oh, I like you, but then she's flaking on a date or some bullshit like that. Or she doesn't give you the biggest one. Oh, I can't make it. And she doesn't give a counter offer or something like that. Like, sorry, I can't make it. I can hang out with you, whatever. Or you tell her, oh, you flaked. All right, well, you got to buy the first round of drinks on the next one. She doesn't respond or she doesn't want to. She's not willing to do that, to right the wrong. You already know she don't like you like that. So you just move on to the next girl.
And then she'll be like, I really want to see you. No, you don't.
Yeah. You know? So a woman's actions, bro, dictate everything, guys. Yeah. Like, you don't listen to what she says. Always watch what she does. And I'll say, the more money you have, the more clout you have, the more you have to watch that even more.
Yep.
Because when you have some kind of status or whatever, they're going to look for a come up. And you need to, I would say you need to screen even harder. If you got money and status, all this other stuff,
they're going to try to finesse you.
You need to get physical with her right away and see where she stands. And if she's like, oh, I don't feel comfortable about that. All right, cool. No worries. And then you just back up and you just like, you know, retract the attention and walk out. Because a lot of girls will sit there and tolerate you when they don't like you like that just for your money. So you got to know right off rip. Like it's, you know, women get turned on like a dial knob. Men get turned on like a light switch. You got to turn that dial knob up nice and slow. Obviously, don't be an idiot. Like, hey, come here. Ooh, and you like grab her boobs or something like that. Don't do that. But you need to slowly escalate and see if she complies with it. And if she don't, you already know where you stand, man. You know?
Cool.
Okay.
Does that help? And does that? Okay. We gave the guy a lot of game, right? The guys get a lot of game there.
Kind of like the same question, but like for you guys, should we watch what you do or should we watch what you say?
Same, yeah.
So for guys, honestly, you should watch what we do. But thing is, men are more a man of the word, because like most guys, they're very upfront and honest to an extent. So guys that have a very, I would say, keen way of like business and, you know, being, how to put this? Guys that have like a lot of value, they're a man of their word for the most part. And when it comes to girls, however, sometimes guys that want to get laid, they'll play a game to get what they want. So you got to see, okay, cool. What's this guy about? Is he really about me? Is he showing up? Is he like setting up dates? Is he like really like taking time and effort to be with me? Or is he just saying, hey, you know what? I missed you, blah, blah, blah. I'm not showing any effort. So once again, the same thing. You got to vet the guy, vet the girl the same way, see their actions. And then over time, you'll see, okay, he's really about me or not. So.
Period. Yeah, with a man, you definitely got to do the actions as well. The thing with women is that it's, because I say for women, like you got to focus on keeping the guy around. A lot of girls, you know, one of the top questions we get from ladies is, hey, I hooked up with this guy. He ghosted me. Why did he ghost me? And what it comes down to a lot of the times for the women, and they don't like hearing, they don't like me saying this when I say it, but with a man, you got to understand, once you have sex with a man, it's on you to keep him around. It's not on him anymore to court you. Like he still should, but he's going to continue to court you and treat you well if you add value. The problem is that a lot of women think that if I just give him sex, that's enough. And that's not true. Like that might work for like a simp or a guy that isn't that well versus women, or a guy that doesn't have options. But let's be honest, all of you guys probably want a guy that's 6 feet tall or taller, makes $100,000 a year, looks good, confident, in shape, etc. There's a typical avatar of women, what they prefer. So if you want a higher status man like that, you got to get on his program and add value to the point where you're indispensable. And what I mean by that is he can't necessarily switch you out for another girl. You know what I'm saying? Because the other thing too, another unfortunate reality I'm gonna tell the ladies, is that when you deal with a certain caliber of men, you're gonna have to share them sexually. Keyword sexually. So if he runs around and smashes other girls, are you the one that he's gonna come back home to? Are you the one that he spends money on? Are you the one that he takes care of? Are you the one that gets his non-sexual attention? He'll listen to your problems. You guys could talk about situations.
Look at her face, man.
The
She's question, like, uh-oh.
You know what I'm saying? So, so if it is, and most importantly, is he willing to die and protect you in times of peril? If the answer is yes, then you need to accept the fact that he's probably going to fuck other girls if he's of a certain status. Like, it is what it is.
It'd be like that sometimes.
Yeah, that's how it is. Because you guys got to remember, once you deal with a certain caliber of man, beauty is common, high value men
ass
or not.
Everywhere.
You know, you can't, they have the leverage now because there's hot chicks that are turning 21, 18 every single day. And a man that makes $1 million a year has no problem dating a chick that works at fucking McDonald's. Yeah. You, however, don't have that. Like, as a woman, the more money you make, the more status you have, etc. You can't date down like we can. Yeah. So we have more options the more we elevate ourselves.
Why can't we date down?
Who wants to date
you
down?
You don't want
to
date down.
You want to
date down.
You
want to
date down?
You
want to
date down?
No. Guys. She already answered it earlier. She took a guy's virginity and she left him.
No.
Done.
That's
done.
Not-
Ouch. Done. Like, done. Like,
No, but the thing is, you're putting so many people.
Like, if I fall in love with somebody and I'm super rich and he works at McDonald's, oh well, he works at McDonald's. I'm still in love with him. Like,
you say that, but the reality is, like I always say, social constructs don't adhere to reality. That's a Disney fairy tale. That's not the way women operate with men. Uh-uh. And as a man, women want a leader, and your own actions showed us that because you had sex with a virgin, you liked them, but you still left him. Why? Because he was ill-equipped to be a leader in your relationship.
You. Or I wasn't ready. Mm-hmm.
Like, he was beneath you.
Or I wasn't ready.
It's not that.
Put on the cap.
Stop the cap. It's not. Stop
the cap. So you're telling me if your dude was a bum, worked at McDonald's, but you loved him.
Just because he works at McDonald's. Hold on.
And all he did was go to McDonald's, come home, watch TV. You would still love him?
I mean, working at McDonald's doesn't make you a bum.
I never said, okay. Take out the bum. All he did was go to work, come home, I do nothing. You still love him?
I mean, he's going to work. He's trying to make a living. He's trying to find his path. Like, it's harder for some people than it is for others.
He's been here
like,
for 2 years, five years.
Like, damn. I would encourage him to try finding a different avenue of revenue, but maybe, like, he's just, like, stuck. Like, there's circumstances that make people end up in situations like that, and I don't think that I would just rule out everyone that's in those circumstances just because they're below me.
It's not just black and white. It's really not.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So, hold on.
Get some real quick.
Yes. Ladies, I think I am the oldest one here. Yes.
29.
To be honest.
Listening.
To be honest, when you have a certain degree and you make a certain amount of money, you want that man not even equal. You want him to be more. Mm-hmm. Just because... Okay, so I'm 21. You know, 21, we could struggle. We could build together. We are at McDonald's. I'm a waitress. We got this, When you start getting to my age, I've already struggled. I've already went to school. I got my degree. I make my money. Sweetheart, if you're 30 and up and you're not even close to that, no, I'm not even talking to you just because your struggling should have already happened. Mm-hmm. We should have already gone through that. No, so maybe for some of you that are younger, you know, I encourage you build with your man, you grow, you struggle, you go to school, you start that business. But when you start getting to an older age, the men that you're looking for are older. And at that time, you want that man to be successful and more than you. Because then if he's not, honestly, you're just going to see him as less. You won't admire him. You won't be proud of him. You're just going to see him as, what are you, just like, dick? Like, no, I can get that everywhere. No, 100%. You need to look up to your man.
Don DeMarco? DeMarco for that one.
If you don't, you're going to end up not respecting him, and therefore you can't submit to him. So I submit to men. It's submission. I submit to men that's on a mission.
Mm-hmm. Fact. You can't love a man that you don't respect.
Fact.
Yeah. You can't.
Yeah, and I get what you're saying. Like, and this, no offense, this is why we tell men on this podcast all the time, don't listen to female dating advice because all they're going to do is make you a better beta male.
Yep.
Because the thing is this, attraction.
It sounds nice.
Attraction is not a choice, ladies. Like, there's certain things that men do that just turn a woman on without her subconscious. She ain't even going to know it. As a matter of fact, there was a study done back in like 2016 where they showed women erotic images and they also attached electrodes to their genitals. And they asked them, hey, does this arouse you? And they showed them like politically correct things like men and women kissing. They showed them monkeys banging, whatever. The men, the heterosexual men, basically they tapped on the button and everything that they were shown that aroused them, like heterosexual sex, lesbians, whatever, They tapped it and it was congruent with their getting aroused, their genitals getting aroused. With the women, however, they would only click on things that were politically correct. However, their genitals showed otherwise. So when the monkeys were banging, the lesbian sex, the heterosexual sex, whatever, the women were getting turned on, but the women only clicked the button that was politically correct. So what does that show? It says that a lot of the time women are not going to be honest about what arouses them or what really turns them on, because the things that turn women on are politically incorrect and they don't want and are unflattering. Women don't want to be looked at as hoes. Yeah. Regardless, you could take the most promiscuous woman, you could take fucking, you know, what's these chicks, girls, city girls, whatever city girls. It is, they could talk about it in their rap and all the shit. Oh yeah, and the niggas that are give me money, all of a sudden the six figure nigga, whatever. Even the most promiscuous women are gonna exercise discretion to some degree with men. Period. You know what I'm saying? It's not natural for a woman to be promiscuous. So women, in the back of their mind, deep down, know that the more dudes that they smash, the more they lower their value. So what are they gonna do? They're gonna want a guy that's better than them. You know? So I get what you're saying. This sounds nice on paper, Disney fairy tale, but. Yeah. Attraction is not a choice. You know what I'm saying? And women always say, I want a nice guy. I want a guy that's going to be court, you know, court me and be a gentleman, all this extra shit. That doesn't work. Ask every night a nice guy that watches this podcast. They all get curved. Girls don't smash them. They get left. You know?
I mean, also, like I am, like you said, you're an older woman than me personally. And I am just 21. So right now, I'm not necessarily looking for a man that has all this finance backing him and all these like amazing opportunities, you know, like. I'm going into my senior year of university and I'm going to become an
But here's the thing. It's not the money though. We talk about this on the podcast explicitly. It's not the money.
Yeah.
It's the freedom that money creates. Women and men look at money very differently.
The lifestyle.
That's the thing. But people of my age, like right now, a lot of people don't have like that financial freedom. Like I know right now my parents pay for a lot of my bills still while I'm getting my footing and I'm about to go into my career. Mm-hmm. So I just.
So you have less pressure to care about a partner having money. But what I am saying is that like a lot of women in your age group tend to gravitate towards men that have their financial situation set up, not because of the money. I want to make that very explicit, guys. It's not because of the money. It's because it's the freedom and the opportunity that money presents. Mm-hmm. You know, I always say like a man will make $1,000 a day and he'll say, oh, if I do this for 30 days, I'll make $30,000 a month. A woman make $1,000 a day, go for 5 days, be like, all right, cool. Rent's paid. I got all my bills. I'm going to fuck. I'm going to chill. Mm-hmm. Because men and women look at money very differently. Men understand that their value comes from how much money they earn. Women understand money is a means to an end to get what they want out of life. Chanel bags, experiences, trips, whatever. There's a reason why 80% of the consumer base is women. 3/4 of debt held by women. So we look at money very differently. So I get what you're saying. Like, I don't care about if he works at McDonald's or whatever, but you do care about his ambition, the lifestyle he could provide, his habits, and you know, and his confidence. Potential. And that's, unfortunately, I always say with men, your confidence comes from your accomplishments and your competence. If you don't have competence and accomplishments, it's very difficult for you to be confident, therefore making you less attractive, period, because it's got to be working in tandem together. So even though I get what you're saying on paper, like it sounds good, like I like you for whatever, it just doesn't work, you know?
Work.
And it's just a Disney fairy tale. Disney
guys, business. Get your Instagrams ready for a smash.
Oh, yeah.
Marry. And friend zone.
So we'll finish up the questions here. Did I answer your question, though, kind of? I know you said it's generalities, but with a man, you got to add the value to him. To want him to keep you around.
Any more questions?
I get it. I just don't like the answer.
No.
It's okay.
It'd be like that. Be like
any
that.
More questions? Yeah.
Any questions?
Can I have a slight add-on?
Sure.
So I know some people may think of me like some other type of way, but I know that I've dated a man that's been in prison before. So it's all about the potential. It's all about the mindset. I don't know. It's all about your vision. I'm a person that has a vision. I may not be exactly where I want to be right now, but I know where I'm going. And that's really what matters to me. As long as your words back up with your actions and so forth and so on, then I really can't.
Well, we had a podcast earlier today and we said the top 5 things that kill a woman's attraction. Number one was actually lack of ambition.
Yep.
Because like I said, money is just a personification of your ambition.
Yep.
You know, you don't have to have the money right there and then. But, you know, ambition is a good predicator of that potential success.
Yep.
Anything else?
Yeah. So sure. I kind of wanted to also add to it.
Sure.
So I feel like a man has to be able to keep up with me type thing. So I can handle myself, my bills, my car, everything that I want to do. If I want to go to a studio, I can't, you know, like I need my man's with me. I want I can't say the word.
You want an entrepreneur. You want a guy. Yeah. In other words, you don't want. I always say on the podcast,
like a man that works for himself type thing. Because that's what I do. So it's like I need someone who's either at the same level as me or someone who's like really balling.
Let's
like,
be honest. Let's be honest. Women don't want their equal. They want a superior.
Yep.
And superior, that's what we tell. We teach guys. We teach 100%. Guys to be that on the podcast.
They have to minimum.
She like, wants you to be taller than you, more money than her, more confident, dress well, in shape, etc. Women don't look for an equal. That's
things.
A whole bunch of bullshit.
Yeah.
Women don't want an equal. That's why I always laugh at 50-50 partnerships or this is a team effort. No, it's not.
Right.
You're the leader. She follows. Period. Women are incapable of leading men. It doesn't work. You know,
they,
and I think
they want a guy that figured it out already or yeah, as well.
Exactly. Strong. They want a leader, man. And the only way you can lead, if you're a leader, you are by default not equal to the partner. Period. Like this whole 50-50 partnership, whatever. Sorry, ladies, you might have believe in that. Mm-mm. It's cap. It's all a bunch of bullshit. Men have to be the leaders. Right. You have some?
So what about the doms out there that be whipping and lashing all y'all?
Ooh, I love that.
That's
all right, so let me answer that. We have a friend, good friend of ours, Sterling Cooper, porn star. Shout out to him. Go check his YouTube channel out.
Yep.
We talked about this in detail. So, yes, there are some women that are doms, but let me tell you, though, women that are doms typically do it for like an ego reason, and they're not actually aroused by the men that they're dominating.
Facts.
As a matter of fact, they laugh at them and clown them and do it 9 out of 10 times to get paid, right? And they do it to the man, but they're not actually aroused by said man. They do it to get the bag or whatever the hell, because these men that want to get dom typically have money, higher socioeconomic status. It's a very good niche that a woman can get into, but she is not aroused by that man. So that's two different things.
And we know a lot of them.
Yeah, facts.
So those guys that want to be dommed, they're like CEOs or like high executives, and they're never told no.
Yeah.
So they want someone to say you're a piece of
Which
shit.
Is weird,
da, 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 da,
yeah.
So,
and our boy Sterling, he's in the porn industry. A lot of girls that he knows get call outs to do that type of shit privately for, you know, high earners. And he tells every single one of them comes back, laughs at the guy, and they don't fuck him.
No respect.
They just step on him with some heels, fuck him up a little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe if they do anything sexual, he's paying a premium and they don't actually enjoy it. So this whole dom thing, it's cap as well. Women are not aroused by men that they can dominate. Period.
No, no, sorry.
Okay, so smash, marry, and friend zone. So guys, get your Instagrams ready.
And, we're going to pull up the first Instagram account now. Ladies,
I'm
be brutally honest with the men. They need the help. Don't tell them, oh, well, you know, you're cute. No, hell no. If he looks like shit, then say it.
Okay, we're going to be honest. So
yeah, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Men need honesty.
But I used to be a duck. I like to give people in advance.
I'm just kidding.
Yeah, we know you're a tease already.
And then, so yeah, guys, smash, marry, friend zone, and get your Instagrams ready. Because this shit going to be good. Mm-hmm. So,
if he broke, he got to look really good.
So, yeah, it's going to be lit. So, yeah, guys.
How much money,
baby? No. So, one of each.
No.
Yeah. Take one and pass.
Honestly, even if he's cute, he probably know.
Stroke Happy, who's Mike?
Who?
No, I'm talking super chat.
So guys, if you super chatted, it's $50 for the super chats. We'll take one by one. I think we got a few already, right, Chris?
Yeah, guys, if we got five, if you're trolling in the chat, and don't beg me to be a mod, just I told you guys the rules is what it is. Mods, if I miss anybody, let me know. But other than that, I have everybody. So
guys, the course is down below. DMsOnDemandSystem.com. That's where you're going to find our full Instagram course, how to get followers, how to build a brand, and also how to get girls online from your bedroom anywhere in the world. So there you go.
All right, first one.
I'm missing a Mary.
A Mary?
Oh, yeah.
There should be.
Does anyone have a double of Mary? Yeah. If not, I'll make one real quick. No one has double?
All right, no, I got sir.
It's not a problem. All right, let's.
Trey, could you make a marry?
Captain Foreskin.
Can you imagine showing your friend, hey, look at this. Captain Foreskin.
All right, so let's enlarge this.
He's the love of
Chris,
my life.
No way. Enlarge it so that people can see it.
Oh, here you go.
I do not like that name.
So we got this guy, Captain Foreskin.
Failed already.
Call me daddy.
Just
failed already.
So off rip, we're going to look at his page. And then after three, we'll say, you'll just raise your choice. So don't say anything yet. We're going to go through his page. And then after three, one, two, three, you'll choose your choice. But
and try not to move the pens around too much. It's making too much noise in the mics.
Cool. So here we go. So this is page here, ladies. Captain Foreskin. All right. So would you smash, marry, or friend zone?
There he's done.
One, two, three.
Holy shit. That's unanimous friend zone.
I wouldn't even friend zone you. Like, I don't even want you as a friend.
Okay, but wait. Oh, wow. He said marry you as a friend.
Okay, hold on.
one at a time. We're going to go around. We're going to give one reason why you friend zoned him. And give your thoughts on it. So we'll start over here since you were so vocal about it.
Okay, first of all, your name is weird and you kind of look creepy. Just that.
Okay, awkward. Just not attractive and creepy. All right.
Yeah. I would friend zone you because you like to work out. I like to work out. Maybe we can learn some workouts as friends.
As friends. Okay.
I would marry because I saw guns protection. I like his name. He's funny and he works out. Fitness. I see he's what? Doing other activity. He likes outdoors. I like that too. And he's not ugly like that.
Okay. Cool.
I'd friend zone him just because, I mean, I don't like the name, but I want to know the explanation towards his name. So that's why I'd friend zone him. I don't want anything.
Just because of his Instagram name?
Yeah. I mean,
okay. Fair enough.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Actually, that's a. But
I just I friend zone him because I see he has two kids. I personally don't date guys with kids.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay.
I would, but just him. It seems like he has a sense of humor, so I give him points to that.
It's amazing how pragmatic women are. Like when it like they're not gonna date a man that has kids, but you fucking simps out there will sit there and date a woman that has kids.
But I don't have kids. If I had kids, it'd be a different story.
We're not bashing. We're just saying most guys.
Because ladies.
Yeah.
Most guys will sit there and like be a stepdad or try to be a hero for a woman that has like five kids. She's not attractive anymore. Like they'll sit there and try to put on the cape and save this woman. But when we ask women, will you date a man that has
smart enough to know?
Women are smart enough to know and self-interested enough to know that's a bad bet for me.
Yeah.
Unless the guy has money. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But 9 out of 10 times, most women are smart enough to not cuck themselves. So it's very interesting that you say that.
Trust me, I did it. So I know.
Yeah.
I did it, man.
If he had something more valuable behind himself, like a business or something like that, that I can fall back, then I would change my.
Okay, fair enough. No, thank you for being honest. It's just a learning point for the guys that are watching.
Yeah.
What's your take?
I am friend zoning him because I do not like the Captain Foreskin. I think that's really weird. And the caller daddy is just like coming off really sexual and like there's not a lot of value behind that. And also, you're clearly in a different life stage than I am. Like, you look older than me, you have kids. It seems like you have a job and all of that figured out. And I'm just probably too young and I don't like the way you're coming on. So
all right. Well, thank you for being honest.
All right.
Honestly, I just have a really strong preference in the men that I like, and it does have a lot to do with looks. I'm sorry. I'm honest.
Okay.
That's fine. Yeah.
So he just doesn't meet the sexual arousal.
100%.
Okay, cool. Are you a Knight Rider?
A what?
A Knight Rider? You like black guys?
Men. Yes, sir. I like my men black.
Okay.
My soulmate black.
David Hasselhoff in the house.
There you go. Knight
Rider. Okay.
BBC's winning.
I friend zoned him because I feel like I can learn a lot from you. I feel like you'll be more of my mentor than like somebody I'd be.
Good boy.
Good boy.
Good boy.
Good boy. I don't know. I feel like you would say something to me that I'll be like, damn, yeah. But like, otherwise, like, I can't see you saying something to me that I'll be like, like, you know what I mean? Like,
okay. All right. Interesting. Cool. Your take on it?
He's just not my type. Like, I have a certain type, and yeah, your personality may be A1, but like, if you don't look the part, I can't do it. If I'm not sexually attracted to you or attracted to you in any type of way, your personality.
In other words, you need to look like a domestic abuser for it to turn around.
Oh, it's a joke.
Baby, sexy.
We know your type. Okay.
No, and real quick, I just want to get a quick little, I guess, feeling on the table. Can men and women be platonic friends? Yes or no?
Yes. Absolutely.
Yes. I am right now.
It depends on the situation. Like, depends
Did
on the people.
Did you say, can women be platonic
friends? No, men and women. Can men and women be platonic friends, which means platonic Absolutely. Means non-sexual whatsoever?
Yes. I learned this on the last podcast. No.
No.
Definitely.
Negative.
Nope.
Yeah. So we got, okay, so I see 1, 2, 3, 4s. Maya, what's your take on it?
I'm in the middle, but because I'm not saying a lot, that's why I'm in the middle.
Okay. We don't want to incriminate her. And then what about you?
No.
Okay, no. So I think that's 5 for yes and 4 for no. Nope.
Why no?
We'll get into it. Yeah, we'll get into it at the end. I don't want to influence anybody. Let's continue on with the show. We'll talk about it after. But I don't want to influence anybody.
Hot boy, low-key, $50.
Especially at my age, girls always come at us for not wanting to commit or give a certain amount of attention. But, bro, to become a certain value of man, we can't be getting distracted by y'all nonsense sometimes. Keeping a girl happy is time-consuming. Absolutely, my friend. But here's the thing. Let me give you guys a little secret. The woman gets happy when you make yourself happy and become the best version of yourself. Because when you win, the woman wins. But when you try to sit there and take her out on expensive ass dates and do all this extra stupid shit, buying her bags, whatever,
too much,
and not focusing on yourself, you're going to lose. Because anytime you make a woman a focus of your life, she's going to get bored and leave you. You need to make yourself the main focus, and then she follows your lead. It's your world. She's just living in it. Not the other way around. A lot of you stupid motherfuckers get in the girl's world, and women aren't built to lead. They're literally designed to be repulsed by a guy that can't bring them into their own world. All right, Zentience. Women will see you as a liability if she provides both emotional and financial support. Facts. That's why you got to make more money than her. Moreover, I've said this before, be a bum and be discarded. Become and be rewarded. Furthermore, Becky, as women hit 30 plus, pregnancies drop. You can wait. You can't wait for him. Okay.
There you go.
Fair enough.
Facts.
All right. And
we not got some... everyone wants kids, though.
Facts. How old are you?
I'm 25.
Your mindset's going to change drastically in the next 5 years.
Everyone says
you.
That, but I don't think so.
But
thinking and mind changing is two different things.
Yeah. Yeah.
The thought of pregnancy gives me actual nightmares. Same. Like wake up sweating type shit. I don't. That's like one of my biggest fears, to be honest. I might adopt one day, but as in me personally, birthing a child, not gonna.
It's one of our superpowers.
Yo, I will get a surrogate. I will adopt. IVF. I am not giving birth to a child.
Oh, that shit is scary. That's so much scarier than it sounds like.
You guys gotta remember. You guys gotta remember. I'm gonna. You guys could say fuck off. I don't agree with you. Whatever. But here's the thing. You guys are in your prime right now.
Yeah.
21, 25. Mm-hmm. You guys are still attractive. You still get attention from men. You're able to hook up with celebs, whatever it is. I'm telling you right here, right now. Well, for her. I'm telling you right here, right now. I'm going to give you the talk that your big brother or your dad or somebody should have told you. As you get older, your options of men are going to dwindle. I'm going to say that again. Yeah. As you get older, the same men that you're able to get now to spend money on you, take you out on dates, etc., are going to become are going to start to dwindle because men are attracted to youth and beauty. Mm-hmm. There's new girls turning 18 every single day. So these high status men are going to go after them and not you anymore. And as your options dwindle, the world isn't going to be as nice and sunshines and rainbows. And you're going to start to realize, okay, I'm tired of having casual sex with high value men. I need someone to fucking lock my ass down. And you're going to want that security and stability to some degree. A lot of the times, children is one of the biggest personification of security and stability.
Oh, no.
Now, you might say, no, but I'm telling you.
Can I tell you something?
You could be the exception to the rule, but most women get baby rabies right around 27, 28, 29, 30. As your ability to bring children to term, that's facts.
Baby rabies.
Yo, funny thing, even if you don't want a child, you want a family. You want somebody to be there with you in bed, traveling. So you want somebody in your life. So it's going to come eventually.
And the last thing I'm going to say, we did a full podcast on this. It's 3 hours long, but if you guys want to put timestamps in there, there's links in there. We did a full podcast on the lies of feminism, how it actually sets up many women, modern day women, to be miserable for the rest of their lives. Yep. 1 in 4 women is on antidepressant medication. A lot of women nowadays in the 2000s have the lowest approval rating and happiness ratings of ever before. When women were less liberated, they were actually reporting higher levels of happiness. And the reality is, and we got the studies in there, is a big predicator of a woman's long-term happiness and fulfillment comes from family and children, not a career.
That's why they buy cats and dogs. So guys, real talk, if you want to invest in cat food and dog food.
Yeah, I have a dog.
Yeah. And another thing I will say too is that the least happy demographic of women, I could give you guys the links and studies after this, is a woman that's earning between 50 to 100K a year that's in her 40s without children.
Mm-hmm. Can I share something with you guys real quick?
Like, yeah, sure. Go ahead.
There's something I found out about myself recently. Yeah. I didn't know. I went to the doctors and he told me that I had like a really high level of prolactin. I didn't know what that was, but it's apparently like you have stress if you're really stressed, or in women that are like producing breast milk or are pregnant, they have prolactin. And I didn't know. I straight up, I'm not pregnant, guys. I know that for a fact.
You're just extra fertile probably.
But no, that shit actually affected me. Like for some reason, the past year, I've just really been focused on getting married and I want to have kids, and that's never been me. And it's just been that way, and it's just my hormones. So I know I'm not the only one going through this, but like I just wanted to put it out there.
Okay. Thank you for being honest about that. Seriously. Yeah. Thank you for being honest about that. And hey, that's not to say like, oh, you might be one of the exceptions to the rule that's saying I don't want kids. Maybe you'll be
dead
that
ass
way.
Like, but all I'm it's saying been a is long that, time you know?
But I'll say this, you're still young and you still have many options. As the options start to close down a bit, as you get older, your mindset might change. So, that's all I'm saying.
I think, like, I don't believe humans are meant to be monogamous. So it's like, it all ties in with, like, my belief in relationships. I don't believe any relationship is perfect or gonna last forever, ever. So it's like, I don't want to have kids with nobody because nobody is permanent in my life. Hmm. I'm not a family person. I don't, my family lives, you know, a couple hours away. They're not that far from me, but I don't have, like, I don't visit my family, unfortunately. Like, I don't have a close relationship with anybody except, like, the people around me that I've, like, my team, the team that I have built that works with me, makes money with me. Like, that's my family type shit.
You have pets?
You want to know what's permanent, though?
One.
You want to know what'll be permanent, which a lot of women want? A son.
A kid.
A son.
A kid is permanent.
Hold on. You got a pet, right?
Why would I want that? Like,
hold on. You got a pet, right?
I have a dog, yes.
A dog, right?
Mm-hmm. That's enough responsibility, right?
Is that like your son?
I wouldn't say that. No. Okay. I would never compare a pet. I don't care how much y'all love your dog. That's not your kid. Yeah. It's not your kid. You can't compare a child to a dog. You could leave to LA for a week and leave your dog with
somebody else,
a roommate, your mom, you know, like a babysitter, like a dog sitter, a fucking dog daycare. But you can't have that same mindset when you have kids, unless you balling, you got big money, you got a nanny that could take care of your kid like that. It's a huge responsibility to compare. It's a huge comparison.
I mean, you might be the exception to
the
rule, but for what you're saying, like, nothing is permanent. I want something permanent, like a son will be permanent.
No one is. Yeah, a child would be permanent, but
that's why I like to ask women when you want to have a kid.
Nobody around that child would be permanent.
Well, when I ask most women and they say they want children, what do you want your first child to be? 9 out of 10 times, it's a son. Because your son is going to be one of the few men that love you unconditionally and will support you through thick and thin versus a boyfriend or husband. But, you know, maybe it might change your mind. You could think about it.
All right.
Send for rent says, stop dressing up your damn dog.
Nah, but hey, she might be the exception to the rule.
All women
that don't want it.
Zentinets, okay.
Hey, you don't have to want to have kids, cool, but you want a high value man. What does he get from you aside from beat up roast beef that he can't get from a young 21 submissive woman who will give him legacies and be on his program? Hint, nothing. Damn, you got a rebuttal to that?
Holy shit.
You got a rebuttal?
Ouch. I'm not just my fucking ability to have a child.
Shots fired. I will say this, though, but that's the only reason men really will get married nowadays.
Well, then fuck that. I don't want marriage.
Oh, right, shit.
Fair enough.
Okay. Talk your shit.
Okay.
Y'all are not everything. Like, y'all, the world does not revolve around men. We don't need y'all. Y'all dessert.
Oh, she hates men.
Y'all are dessert. Okay. No, I don't hate men. Just, I love men. Right, cool. Don't get it twisted. I love
some
men.
Girls on the platform be like,
nah, it's just, love nah, it's just she just doesn't think that they're required, which is fine.
She loves the BBC.
No, nobody's required. A woman's not required. A man does not need a woman. A woman can improve a man's life, vice versa. But you don't need someone by your side. I've survived alone. I'm Gucci. I've known people who've been alone for years more than me. And they survived and prospered.
I mean, me personally, I need, you know.
A lot of people do. Most people, like 90% probably.
Me personally, when I was a little girl, people dreamed about becoming all this stuff. I wanted to be a housewife. I'm going to have my kids. I wanted to be submissive, take care of my husband. And then look, I went to school. I got my degree. I'm independent. I'm alone. I do all of this. But when I was growing up, I wanted to be an educated housewife. And I wanted to submit to my husband and be there for him.
I'm trying to travel. I'm trying
I can
to
travel with him.
Be a rock star. No, see, I'm trying to have a different lifestyle. See, yeah. I'm not trying to have a housewife.
Okay, back on topic.
Okay.
All right, fair enough.
We got underscore tech Julian in the house.
Let's go down this Instagram. So ladies, I'm going to count to three. If you want to say enlarge one of the pictures, just let us know.
Would you
all right,
smash?
So ladies, on three, let's put up what you would put up.
Okay. Yeah, one of his face.
Would you smash, marry,
or that one's from 272 weeks ago.
Okay, scroll up, give a more recent one. Scroll up a more recent one. I guess that one right there is the most recent.
Can you see that?
Click that one top left corner.
The one with
Chris.
The babe.
The one with
all right,
the babe.
All right, 3, 2, 1. What'd you guys do? Okay, unanimous friend zone. Okay.
Friend zone?
All right, we'll start with punch a nigga in the face.
She's not my type, bro.
Okay. Can you say like what like just not arousing, like just not attractive?
Just not attractive. I'm very picky. I'm very, very, very picky. If you're not attractive to me,
you can't
I'm not gonna give you the time of day. Sorry.
Okay.
I can tell you your time.
That's fine.
I like that you travel. Can you keep going? I don't know who the chick is in the photo.
She kind of cute, though. No cap.
I mean, like, really, I can't be, like, cuffing no nigga that got another old friend.
I think the most recent picture.
Oh, yeah. I thought it was his mom. I don't think that's his mom.
Nah, that can't be his mom.
Right, so he looks like a nice guy.
He looks like he looks like he's really cool. Like,
but friend zoned.
Yeah, okay. Like I can go to movies with him or something.
Chris, we got these piling up now, right?
Yeah, we got about five more.
Okay, so let's quick. I mean, not just give us like a quick one shot. Why you're friend zoning him?
If everyone does the same, we can just like understand that it's probably universal. But if they have a different opinion, we could talk about it because we got like a lot of those backed up.
Okay.
Not really our type. Just not attractive.
Yeah. Not attractive enough.
Yeah. You're not cute.
No, not
sorry.
At all.
Not my too short.
Yeah. Too short.
I like chocolate.
Maya?
You should work out. He's too default for me.
Oh my God. Oh man.
She said you're an average nigga, bro.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. I like that.
Okay. And hey guys, cold hard reality. You guys want to know a dirty little secret? Women don't want average men, unfortunately. Average women don't even want average men anymore, guys. Nope. Times have changed with Instagram, online dating, and you know, planes and dudes being able to fly chicks out. Being an average man is not good enough anymore, guys.
A woman will never settle, bro. She'd rather be alone with a dog and cat for her rest of life rather than be with you.
Facts. Bro, real talk. Women will die alone over being stuck with an average man, bro.
Period.
There's women calling in. Shout out to Kevin Samuels. There's women calling in at 30, 40 years old plus. I make 100 grand a year. I will not date a guy that makes 50 grand a year. Fuck that. Dude, I'm not settling. Sorry. And they're by themselves and they're miserable.
Dude, you could be the last man on earth. Yep. She ain't fucking you, bro. Yeah. It's a wrap.
Yeah. So guys, we're here to level help you guys level up.
Level up, bro.
For that point. So, okay. Next person.
Josh with the shot.
Can we, Chris, please enlarge it.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord.
All right.
I don't think.
Bruh, okay.
Yeah.
Smash. Marry,
I was trying to do it quick.
Oh,
okay, everyone is what? Friend zone?
One, two, three.
Pretty. It's universal.
You look nice, though.
Now, Myron, can you tell the chat why this is happening right now?
I'd be his friend. He looked funny.
Yeah, he looked really funny.
I want to get the lady's take, and then I'll get mine. So we'll start with you, Miss Puerto Rico.
Remember, but
why did you friend zone him?
They all did the same. So we want
to. I know that, but like, just quick, why? Why? Because he's.
I mean, like, he's not my type, you know?
Okay.
You need to lose some weight. I'm sorry.
Okay. Maya?
Same thing, and he's just too corny, that's all.
Is Haiti?
Yeah, them poses, man. But, you know, he's not attractive.
I don't like his Instagram. It's not my vibe.
Okay.
Same. Not attractive.
Not attractive? Sex appeal low?
I get, like, Fat Albert from it.
Shit!
Oh, man.
Look, there's someone out there for everybody.
I mean, Fat Albert's cool.
No.
Fat Albert had a bitch.
Hold on, ladies. Like, don't do that. Roast him. Fucking roast him. Tell him what do you want to say.
Hell yeah.
Like, it's not, no. Fat Albert, okay, good. If you want to roast him, I know you want to roast him. Go ahead.
I already know what the fuck I said.
Okay,
someone
so
out
it?
There for everybody, just not for me.
Okay.
Not for me.
All right, bro, I'm going to just keep it a stack, which I wanted to get. I wanted the ladies to go around so you can hear different perspectives. Number one, you're fat. Unfucking acceptable. That was number four in our top five reasons a woman won't want to fuck with you. One of the few things you have a choice of in life is whether you want to be fat. You're in control of every fucking calorie that comes into your life, and you're in control of every fucking barber that touches your head, nigga. What are you doing?
Yo. I'm going
to
say one thing.
You need to lose weight, bro.
Bro, you got titties, bro. Come on now. Come on now.
I don't know who twisted your dreads, but they did a fresh job. Like,
yeah,
I just want to say
you
that.
Yeah,
them parts are crisp.
Yeah. Someone said
that shit mad empty under there.
Yeah.
Under
there, like, yes, man.
No.
Yes.
Yes.
Like,
no.
Where are we looking?
That shit look like little black Cheetos on the and his glasses squeezing his head.
Yo, my boy.
We had to do all
my boy. My boy.
Are they shiny?
Black Cheetos?
They look fake. Why are they shiny?
Honestly, I go like this course probably can't help you, bro.
Damn,
I can like this man,
no. Maya, what else you got to say about this nigga, bro? Yo, you need to feel this pain.
Yo,
you need to feel this. It
his
is
ears red.
Yo,
hearing what I'm saying.
Go ahead, let's go. Roast him.
His glasses little as shit. They squeezing
the fat.
That's not a cute picture.
Yo, real talk. This course can't save you, bro.
Yo,
I ain't gonna lie, bro. This one person will say, bro, this course can't save you. This course can't save you, bro.
That's
the type of picture I take of myself in the mirror when I'm trying to look at my pimples.
You need the gym,
bro.
He
really
picture.
Was like this. He really
Yo,
was like this.
Maya, hold on.
Who told you it was okay to post?
Guys, one mic at a time. Maya, what else you got to say? You got to roast him. You got the hat on.
Nah,
anything else?
If you go through his Instagram, I won't stop. But I'm stopping right now. I'm gonna let him live.
Live.
She said little ass glasses and Cheeto twisties, man. I love it. Black Cheeto twisties.
No, but like the show earlier, for this person, bro, you need to hit the gym definitely. And your pictures can't really improve if you're like fat. You can't really improve fat. Hold on.
No, yeah, bro. You can. Yeah,
how?
You can. Yeah, you
can. You can show only face, but when she sees you in person, bro, it's a wrap. So
I don't know. Some tubby men can get it though. Like I'm not even gonna play. Yeah. Some tubby men can really
angle.
Get it.
I mean, ladies, I don't ladies, like ladies. That. It's okay. All about the angles.
Hold on.
They do be funny though.
Women, ladies. We got on this podcast. We teach guys to operate on probabilities and not possibilities.
Oh,
okay.
Excuse me.
Possibilities of a girl might like him being tubby. Okay, that's there. But
money.
We're about probabilities. 90% of women are gonna find you repulsive if you're fat to that degree. So lose the fucking weight. We're not gonna give you no Disney fairy tales, nothing, bro. Unacceptable. Lose the goddamn weight.
I love, bro. Dude, I need to lose weight too, bro. Yeah. I lost 25 pounds. Yeah. Like, I was fat as fuck.
No, you ain't gonna get no sympathy over here, bro. Nope. You already know how I feel about fat people. You're a fucking loser. Yep. Go lose the goddamn weight. All right, JRM, $50. This is one of the most vapid group of women ever on the show. They're so bad, I wouldn't even smash. I would just walk. They have zero appeal to me as a high-value man. Can I say zero again? You guys want to say anything back to him?
Hey! There you go.
You couldn't even put your face in your fucking profile picture.
You know why? Because you wouldn't even be able to get the time of day from us. That's why.
I would love to see his page.
I will say... Maybe the mindset is not what you want, but I guarantee you go slide in their DMs after this.
Yeah. Course,
I guarantee you.
A lot of guys talk shit on the thing and then be sipping after.
Men right. Don't care. Next guy. Men care about mindset.
Guys.
Do not.
I would love to see
it. Shahrazan Khan.
Shahrazan. Okay.
Is he Jewish?
Okay. I don't like this.
Hey, you guys. Wait until three. Oh, I don't want you to influence each other. All right. Play some basketball. Cool. Oh, all right, guys. Genius. I'm going to count to three on three. Throw them up. Okay. One, two, three. Throw them up. Okay. We got, all right, a couple Marys and one smash and a friend zones. All right, let's go around the table.
Cool.
Oh, wait, what did you have?
This one's kind of questionable for me. I don't know if I want a friend zone him or smash him.
Okay. So, you know what? We'll make it easy. Why the friend zone, why the smash? Yeah. Real fast.
Because, like, I don't know. He kind of attractive in a way, but like his personality might be just friend zone type personality.
Okay. All right. Fair enough. Attractive, but you know, but he conveys nice guy vibes.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think we would clash in lifestyles, as in like religion, different practices and whatnot. That's something that I probably may not be able to.
Okay. She can't fuck
or
with Muslim
he
niggas.
He may not even be able to.
Yeah. You can't deal with fuck with Muslim niggas. All right. Go ahead.
So the attractiveness, and I think it's kind of lame. The traveling is cool, but it's kind of lame that you're doing the same pose in every, you know, destination you go to. It's kind of like planking or like fetch, you know, trying to make it happen. It's not going to happen.
All right.
I agree with the pose thing. I did not like that. And I just, I don't know.
You friend zone him as well, right?
Yeah.
Friend zone. Okay.
Yeah. He could be funny, but like, no.
Okay.
He looks like he got all his shit in order. I married him.
Okay.
Okay.
I said I'd smash because you know what? My opinion, he got his shit together. One,
okay.
Two, I think he's kind of cute.
All right,
okay, that's, Maya, that's fair.
I'll marry him.
All right,
I'll marry him. He has everything together, and he's still young.
All right,
okay.
Miss Puerto Rico.
I mean, I say like in between too, because you kind of look dorky, but you're kind of cute, and I like guys with you know, big noses.
What? What?
Big what?
Oh, wait, two of my exes have like really big noses, so I guess it's a thing. Oh, wow. He was attractive.
Oh, okay, you like big noses.
Shout out to Mara.
And look at the tattoo.
Fuck you. Okay, yeah, man. So, bro, your profile's right there on the cusp to get it more optimized. Yeah. Get on DMs on demand, system.com, man, because you have some stupid shit here that is definitely getting the girls to possibly friend zone you. I can see it in your eyes when she's saying, like, in the middle. So, we'll help you be
almost
a little
there,
bit more
almost
edgy.
There,
you're
right almost there.
You're right there. Okay, next person.
Raw dog underscore Ken21.
Raw dog. Okay.
That ain't a human.
Let's scroll down.
Your name is funny as shit, dude.
Scroll down. Okay. Scroll down. Okay. All right, ladies. Three,
two, one.
Throw them up.
I got nothing to say.
Okay, one smash, and everyone else is friends. Haiti?
I have nothing to say.
You got to put it up, though.
Well.
Nothing. Friend zone. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Okay. So we'll go around. We'll start with Miss Puerto Rico. Why did friend zone?
Okay.
I mean, I don't know. I just don't like. I'm not impressed by it.
Okay.
I think he looks pretty cool. I think we would have fun going out, and I'd be his like wing girl. I think.
That is not good, gentlemen.
Friend zone.
Maya.
Right. I'll just be his little homie. I wouldn't be your bony.
Nothing.
Nah. I'm sorry.
Okay, speechless. You couldn't even get a rating.
The name concerns me. Are you out here raw dogging everybody, or do you consider yourself raw? That's why I was on the tested? Fence. I didn't want to take a chance, so friend zone.
Real shit.
I just don't like it.
You gave a smash. Why?
I gave a smash because I see that we got some things in common here.
Okay.
So I love the car life. I love his shirt. That's Goku. That's my man's.
Okay.
That's my baby daddy. He don't know it.
Okay. But, Dragon Ball Z fan here.
Sick. So
you don't want it.
So you're hold on. So you're cool with the raw dog?
I think that's like a troll thing. I don't really care for the name.
Nah, he did that serious though.
That might be a problem.
I feel like maybe we could support each other, like. Is career wise, yeah. I see he's trying to do his own flicks or something like on little pictures, but
okay,
miss punch a dude in the face.
Oh,
I was like, something
not cutting it, like she said, is not speaking to me. There's no spark.
Okay, so he want to swing back.
It's
at you,
the
so
rainbow,
you're not
like what is I don't get the style.
You don't like mix prince with prince, like sometimes it looks good, sometimes it doesn't. You look like a mess.
Okay, yeah.
Okay,
next person like, or next victim again. In this case.
Where was he at with the bow tie though?
Big homie Parker.
Okay. Okay, let's scroll down, ladies, get the thing ready,
the money, the gym.
Where's his face? There's no face.
On three, one, two, three.
Throw him up.
You can't see.
Okay, one smash and unanimous friend zone. Okay, we'll go with
I don't know, this one is questionable because it's like he kind of speaks to me, but it's like, my man, you're not showing your face or nothing. Like, what are you, insecure?
Gotcha.
Do you feel like you're ugly?
So that's a no from you?
I
feel like he may be doing or a profession that, you know, you really don't need to have your face everywhere, you know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's throwing you sketchy
marks. That could be a thing. But the main thing that made me friend zone him was I need to know what you're doing.
Okay.
Nope.
You?
So I can't see your face. I don't know what your teeth look like.
Oh, okay.
That scares me.
Fair enough.
I like
teeth are important, guys.
Dead ass.
I have like friendzone all these people because I like really creative people, and all these Instagrams are just like so boring. Like,
not artsy enough.
Why does he have a video of just holding cash?
I agree with that.
What is
that? Don't show off.
Hold on, ladies. You'll get a chance.
One at a time.
It's like it says desperate. It's like I'm trying to get a girl, but don't want to show. Like, why don't you want to show your
Miss Haiti?
Personally, I've dated someone who shows off money, and now that's just cringy to me, so.
Nope.
Okay. Maya, you gave a smash.
No way. Yeah, I like low key guys that get money.
Okay.
Okay.
Scammers. I have friends on him.
Look. Scammers.
We'll work out together.
Yeah. Okay. So, okay. Too corny for you or something? Or what?
No, it's just he looks like a friend. Like, okay. I could work out with him.
Nope.
Okay, Miss Puerto Rico.
Yep. No, just like the other girls. Like, I don't like anyone to like show off money.
All right.
I got to say one thing, man. I am very passionate about Instagram, right? And I see shit like this all the time. I'm like, bro, what are you doing? My thing is, right? Stupid. If you're on Instagram, bro, at least show proper pictures and a good lifestyle. It's not that hard, bro. Like y'all niggas need help, bro. I swear to God. Continue.
All right, next person. Mike, no go zones. Let's scroll down here.
No,
what is this?
That might be him on the. That's him on the lip right there. This
is
him
there on the
left.
Pass?
We're not going to guess.
Know?
We're
not I don't even guess. Want him I to be my
just,
friend.
All right, guys, please just keep it silent until we do raise the things, and you can give your opinions.
Man,
all right, three,
two, one.
This
hurt my soul, bro.
Friend zones all around, Miss Colorado.
Yeah, man.
That is a friend zone.
Bro,
as well.
You need a course.
He just looks like somebody else's uncle. Like, I don't know.
You need a course ASAP, bro.
Yeah, that's a unanimous L. You have no pictures of yourself, dude. Bro. Like, what the fuck? This is trash.
See, girls don't know how to use Instagram properly. Guys don't. That's the problem, bro. If you did, you'd be.
Man. Yeah. It was like, where's they were looking now? They already knew what time was. All right. Okay. Next guy, John Cotton. Oh,
here we go.
Scroll down.
Famous player.
Keep going around.
A lot better here.
All right.
All right.
Oh,
okay.
He's sexy.
All right, ladies, smash or pass. Three,
smash,
two, smash for Mary friend zone.
Three, two, one.
Okay, they already got their bam, bam, bam. All right, good.
Okay,
good. Excellent. Awesome. Excellent. Let's start with Puerto Rico to my left. You see, you gave a smash.
Oh, I mean, I smashed smash because you're cute, but I wouldn't marry you because you would look like you would break my heart.
Okay.
Okay.
I would marry you. I like your profile picture. I love anime.
All right.
So we have that in common.
Awesome.
You're hot.
Maya?
Nice.
I'll smash.
Okay.
Yeah. I'd smash, but you probably really conceited, bro.
Okay.
I meant to smash. Accidentally hit up Mary, but I meant to smash because he likes anime. That's it.
Okay.
I put friend zone. I don't like the Instagram. Why does he have the same picture posted twice? And the one in the middle is like the same picture and like a different font. Like, I just don't like it.
Okay.
So I put smash because one, the anime, and two, because he's sexy. What?
Okay.
Fine. It's a smile for me.
Okay.
Yeah. Jeez.
Hey, man. Dark skins are winning.
There you go.
Bosses, right?
So I guess you would punch him back.
Yeah. So see, guys,
I won't even put my hands on him.
But yo, guys, notice, right? He has a very how to put this, appealing face to the girls. So what does he do? He highlights that as his most of his posts. So
respect,
using his
his
strength to his advantage. That's very good. So there
and
you go,
also
bro.
His beard is groomed.
Yep.
Manscaped.com/freshandfit, guys. 20% off.
And
beard is groomed.
His smile, bro. Remember we see all the time on Instagram.
Teeth got to be nice.
You need a smile, bro. Nice teeth. Very important.
And then last thing I want to say, I just want to give this last tip for the guys.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, a woman is only gonna like anime on you if you're good looking.
Yeah.
So some of you got fat losers out there. Whoa, she likes anime? Let me just wear anime shirts. No, motherfucker.
No.
Anime, they'll be interested in the anime byproduct if you meet the requirements first. I want to make that very clear. The cart's got to be, the horses, you can't put the cart before the horse. You got to be attractive first. Then you can put in the anime and the interest.
Yo, bro was well-groomed and nice teeth.
There you go.
There you go.
All right, good stuff, man. Still get on the course because we can optimize it because you have
you need more followers.
You need more followers and your pictures are like, what the fuck are you having three pictures, bro?
Yeah, back to back.
All right, ladies.
Would you marry friend zone or smash this dude right here?
I think that's him right there with the dreads. Okay, yeah, that's him. All right.
How old is he?
Scroll up to the top, Chris. Up to the top.
He didn't say.
Nope, that's not him. So three, two, one. Throw him up. Okay, that is
resounding friend zone and one Mary.
Of course, the one girl. Okay. I think I know. That's gonna be interesting to take from you.
Wait, who's that Mary?
Me.
Soda.
Okay. I am curious.
Give us your take. Why the friend zone?
That's a whole dub right there. Nope. The whole style, everything.
I think you're an artist. Like, I like the aesthetic. Like, I don't know. It's the aesthetic for me that I'm like, cool, you can be my friend.
Okay.
All right.
You're also an artist. So what's your take on this?
Oh, so on like an art view, it's beautiful. Your page, I think, is very pleasing aesthetically, whatever, all that. But you look kind of young to me. Like, you look like a young bro. Like,
yeah, like you're in high school.
The Mary.
Yeah.
Let's go.
I want to hear this one.
Like, he's young, which obviously none of the other ones have been that young. And that works well for me. Also, I really like the style. I like that he cares about his Instagram. He's making it artsy. Ooh. Like, I like people who, like, put, like, time and effort into, like, looking cool or, like, different on social media. And honestly, I think he's just, like, cute, too.
All right. Miss Submission is the mission.
Yeah, he looks young to me, so there's nothing wrong with him. Like, I agree with the other girls. I like his Instagram, but I'm not a cougar.
Nope.
I love his style. I think he's super artistic, and that's.
But you friend zoned him though, didn't you?
Yeah. I did. No,
yeah. Oh,
I
think
make that very clear. So friend zone.
Super friend zone, but super cool and dope.
Maya.
I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I don't think that's artistic. I think that's lazy. Like, I know art when I see it, and having a want to be artistic Instagram is not it unless it's really artistic.
Damn. Real.
Okay.
Friends.
Okay.
I don't think you're cute and you are really young and I don't really care about art.
No.
If it's not pink.
Thanks for being honest.
I hurt. Sorry, girl.
No, it's fine.
I mean, if it's making money, then maybe.
Yeah.
Always.
No.
This doesn't do it for you.
Yeah. Doesn't he look like Joey Badass? A little bit?
Man.
No.
All right.
Don't do Joey like that.
All right, guys. Stop sending super chats. We got seven more.
Cool, seven more.
Seven more?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
All right.
Wow. All
right. All right. So this is what we're going to do.
If it's all friend zone, it's pretty much universal, like I said earlier. But if anyone's different, we'll just ask them why they're different.
Okay. Yo, I niggas throwing this money into the fucking thing to get your profile roasted. Why aren't you on DMs on demand, man? What the fuck?
Guys, get the course. You're going to get 40 hours of content and realize, dude, get this, right? After this course, you're going to understand how to use Instagram to get girls, money, and brand yourself. You can't beat that, and network too as well.
Okay, so let's scroll down this one real quick. All right, guys.
That's it.
Well,
It's self-explanatory.
Yeah, that's...
But he's kind of cute.
Yeah, he's not ugly.
Yeah, he's not ugly.
Looks like he's
just super my friend, but not my
He looks like a baby.
Friend zone. Get the course,
friend
brother.
Friend zone, bro. Yeah, you got to get that, man.
He looks too nice.
I'm not going to lie, bro. You give beta male vibes, 100%. Too much of a nice guy.
Beta male. Cute, though.
All right, let's continue on. The only minor.
Cool.
He's a minor.
Same. The only minor is his name.
Yeah. Oh,
underscore the only underscore.
Ladies,
my bad.
Ladies,
friend zone.
Oh shit, yeah, unanimous friend zone.
Another one,
goofy. Yeah, you need a course, bro. Yeah, you need to lose weight too. You need to lose weight. Listen, if you're fat and you're not clean shaven,
Oh no, I think if he's a little more slim, the goofiness I like goofiness. But
okay,
if you're a little more slim.
Then. Okay.
Bro,
fair enough.
If you're overweight, you better have some clout or some money. At least. Yeah. You still need to work on that.
Semi-automatic.
At least
or
money.
Some drip, bro. Seriously.
There you go.
Some semi-automatic. Okay. Ladies,
click on
three, two, throw one with his face in it.
Okay.
All right.
Already showed.
Ladies, go ahead. Oh, friends. Okay. One Mary. Okay.
Two Marys.
Okay. The two ladies that marry.
Why?
There's a lot. So I love the traveling. I love the fashion. And he's sexy. What
okay.
else do you want?
Okay. Awesome. Yeah, you like the dark skin? What about you, Maya?
I like the switch up on the fashion. It's street, but it's also upscale in some. So I think he knows how to carry himself with a woman outside.
All right. Nice. And then for the ladies that said friend zone, one sentence, one liner way.
Not my type.
Not yours.
Nice clothes, but not my
I don't even like his clothes. I feel like Gucci is just like, what are you doing? Like, that's like new money. Like, let me just flex that I have
to
this look in my
pocket. I don't care about the clothes.
Nice. You know how much that Gucci jacket is.
I know, but the point is, it doesn't matter how much.
Designer.
It doesn't prove that you dress good.
It's like
Gucci.
A supreme trend.
Good,
like,
though. He's dressing good.
And it doesn't mean he has money.
No, but like, you can't make that the pointer
Ladies.
Of everything.
My nigga, imagine, though.
It doesn't mean he has money.
I don't know.
I'll say this, guys.
Can I change my answer?
What's your answer now?
I want to smash.
Oh, you do?
I don't know. I just like the way he carries himself. Like, it's not even confidence. Exactly what he's wearing. It's just the way that he's that like, yo,
right.
This is
Well, slide in DMs, man. Send
DMs.
That pick. No,
there you go.
But yeah, Miss Blondie, you guys got to pretty much be homeless to get her, guys. So wear the homeless outfit and she'll go after you. Okay, let's go. Next person. Yeah. We're going to run through these quickly. Okay.
Bro. Why would you do that?
You are trolling, my friend. You must be trolling.
Yeah.
That's a bot.
Either you archived all your posts or you just said fuck this shit.
It's Matt. Yeah, he brought star earlier.
Ross is like, nah, hell no.
He said no.
That's
funny.
He's smart.
That's actually.
He's smart, man.
Yeah, he bought the course. He was like, I ain't going to get roasted.
Yeah.
All right, Poetic Steez. Let's do it. Skateboarder.
Skater.
I can't see his face.
I feel like he's
scroll up to his face. This guy actually showed his profile earlier a couple of days ago. That's him on the right.
He lit.
Is that a video?
Yeah.
Can I see his face?
All right. So three, two, one. Go ahead.
I can't see his face.
They can't see
we'll
his face.
We'll show the face. We'll show the face. There you go. That's his face. Click it, Chris,
so
right there.
This video going.
Cool.
There you go.
All right. Ladies.
Yeah, he looked young.
One smash went to Mary.
I married.
Smash.
I'm married
okay.
too.
Okay. Okay. Let's go around the table.
Oh, yeah.
You smash? Okay. Why?
I might smash.
Might smash.
It's questionable. Because he kind of looked decent, but it depends on his personality.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Looks are there for you, but you don't know. He's got to be able to handle your craziness.
He's not all the way there, but he's decent.
He's got to be able to handle it. All right. Let's call it.
I also agree. I think he looks very decent. I think he's a cute, attractive man.
Mm-hmm.
I also like him active. Like,
okay.
Whatever you're
okay.
doing, I kind of like him rough, too. So,
okay.
If you're skateboarding, you can take a couple scars. But at the same time, you kind of look douchey. Like, you can't be held down. Like, you just look like you a free spirit. Like, you're so free-spirited, you ain't about having a relationship in the first place.
She got a whole story off of that.
I think he would be cool to hang out with. I hung out with a lot of skaters back in the day. So
friend zone, right?
Friend zone AF.
Yeah.
I put Mary because I just like really like the skateboard like boys. Honestly, like it's just
there
my weakness.
All right.
I put friend zone
I like Skateboard Boys too, but he just gives beta male vibes.
I said Mary. I like Skateboard Boys, and he was skydiving.
Yeah,
he's very adventurous, and he's not afraid to fall. That cool. really is cool. attractive to me.
Yeah, Maya. Same.
I just say friend zone because I would like to do that. I would like to do all of that with a friend, like on that skating.
Okay.
I would say friend zone because just like her, I would like to do those things, but you don't look like you make any money. You only work. You only skateboard. Okay.
Yo, my man just did the ninjutsu sign. Ball. Chris, you saw that?
Oh, no, I didn't see it.
All right. What about you, Miss Puerto Rico?
I
need
friend zone because I just don't like skater boys.
Okay. Okay. How many more we got, Chris?
I think we have
three more.
Three more.
Okay. Let's knock them out.
Boom, boom. Man, I can't believe some of y'all, though.
Jeez, man, you got to get on the course, my friend.
Get on the course, all right. Man. I'm telling you guys, it will change your life, literally.
All right, ladies, get ready.
All right.
Three.
Oh, we got a bite rider here.
Two.
One.
One. Throw them up, throw them up, throw them up, throw them up, throw them up.
Okay, we got some Marys and some Smashes in here.
Okay, cool, cool. All right, we'll start with, I'll punch a nigga in the face.
White smash.
Because he likes adventures and like he likes to do things.
All right.
Okay.
Miss Colorado? She really analyzed it.
I really don't know how I feel about this dude. Can you show me one more time the thingy thing?
God, so picky.
The thingy thing?
I mean, I have friends. I mean, I don't know.
Okay, moving
Can
on.
Can we come back to me?
Yeah, go ahead.
Friend zone, not my type.
Okay.
Friend zone, don't like what he's putting out there.
Okay.
I would just smash. That's it.
Okay.
Friends are not my type.
I'll marry him.
Okay.
I'll marry him. He likes to work out. He's my type. He has tattoos. Mm-hmm. He likes to travel.
Nice.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll marry him too. He has a nice beard.
All right.
There you
and
go.
And then, awesome. Miss Colorado, now that you've been influenced by everyone else.
I don't know. I still feel like I might, like, not. I think our styles would clash. Like, I'm so, like.
Man, you're reading into it too much.
I'm indecisive. Sorry.
Yo.
Okay. Don't take that, guys. If you take her on a date, you better tell her where you guys are going to go eat. I'll tell you that.
I might eat the entire menu in your ass, so come with your bag.
Yo, shit. Okay.
Oh, never mind.
Okay. Don't take her out for a dinner date.
Good Lord.
Don't take her out for a dinner date. Okay. One picture, ladies.
You are trolling, bro.
No.
Three, two,
one.
Throw him up. He has a YouTube channel, 300K, which means he has a pretty big channel.
Yo, open the channel real quick.
Open the channel real quick.
He must be trolling, bro. Has to be trolling. Oh, wait. He look at his bio. Don't tell Fresh and Fit. I have only one picture. Go to YouTube. This must be a troll.
Click his YouTube,
Go to YouTube real quick.
Okay, so unanimous friend zones. Okay.
Hold on. We got to see YouTube. This will play out.
That was easy.
Oh, well.
YouTube.
Looks in its time. Yeah, like, hold on,
Fresh, open it up on the side. But yeah, that's a dub right there. I think that was three, right? Those three of them?
No, we got
one more.
Wait,
no.
YouTube or no? Show the YouTube. Okay. There must be a reason why he did that. I'm curious to find out why he did that.
Chris can open it up on another screen while we do the last guy. That's a shit. Yep.
Dude, I knew it.
What?
That's his channel. He's huge.
Okay, I changed my answer.
Ah! Okay.
He's smart. The cute stuff.
He's smart.
What? So much personality.
If that's you, bro, you're smart, bro. But if that's not you, you're trolling, then there you go.
Probably, you know.
All right, cool. So okay, video game channel looks like. All right, let's go. Continue on to the last person right now. Oh, okay. One girl said Mary. You got clout, bro. See, clout. Some girls will get you chicks.
Pretty much the ultimate equalizer.
That YouTube
equalizer.
Video.
Yeah.
That YouTube link.
All right. Last one here, Chris.
Yep.
Pacific Trash Vortex 1. Okay.
What?
Let's see his page.
Okay, scroll up to the top because he only has one picture of himself, really. Right there, that one with the phone selfie. All right, ladies, three, two,
one.
Throw him up, throw him up, throw him up.
Okay, one Mary. And one
Mary,
smash.
One smash. All right, let's go around. Miss Puerto Rico, why friend zone?
I don't know.
Okay.
You don't have enough pictures for Mary, but for Smash, you're cute.
All right, fair enough. Maya?
Mary, I could look at him every day, and it looks like he's a little more artistic than other people that we saw. And for real.
Real art, not a fraud. Miss Haiti, you giving that look of...
Honestly, I don't know what the fuck I'm looking at, first of all. Second of all, I'm not a fan of those selfie mirrors.
Fan in the window.
Okay. Miss Submission is the mission.
I like that he reads, but not friend zone, because I can't tell what else he does,
Oh, okay. Lucas Music.
Miss Homeless Edition Part Volume 2.
I really like his Instagram, but he looks older than me. Also, that one photo is his profile picture, and it's just not a good picture of him. Yeah. No tagged photos. I don't know what's happening. I don't even know what he looks like.
Friend zone, because he's just not my type.
And you got no clout.
I would have to friend zone him because, I don't know, I like the fact that he reads and that he likes nature. I like the lights, the aesthetic, you know what I'm saying? But what I can't, I just don't, I need to have a combo. I need to know where you're coming from with this.
True.
Give me a creep vibe. I'm good.
Exactly.
Ooh, I don't know. Now that she says
if you got her feeling creepy, I fucking niggas up. I don't know, man. You fucking up, bro. So, all right, cool. Let's go around the table. Ladies, what are your thoughts on the show? Did you hate it? Did you love it? Are we toxic misogynists? Do you want to, I don't know what it is.
Kill us.
Well, not you. Don't give us a real answer on that. But
you want to start?
We'll start with Miss Puerto Rico.
This is my second show with you guys. I definitely enjoy this one way better. Yeah. But it's because I learned to deal with you guys.
Yo, after the last
show, she was the truth.
I don't let it get to my heart. And I don't want to be independent. I want to be a housewife now.
Oh, we changed your mind.
Because
hold on, last time you came on, you were on that rambunctiousness.
I was so mad, like I was just, I wanted to be on World Star, like that girl.
She was heated, bro.
Wait, and how old are you, by the way?
Huh?
How old
she's
are you?
Next she's question, 20.
Huh?
This 20.
How old are you?
Old enough.
Okay, here you go.
No. What? Real talk. So, did the things we tell you, did you find out to them to be true?
I mean, like, sadly, yes. Do I agree with it? No, but sadly, it's the world we live in, and men are like that.
So we're not toxic assholes?
So we're not toxic?
I mean, yes, still, but you know, doesn't mean you're not wrong.
I will say this. A lot of women are watching us now. Our female viewership, I look at the numbers all the time. It's going up. Every week I look, it goes up like 1 or 2%. And it's because you're telling the truth, man. When you tell the truth long enough, people are going to come and tune in because people lie to women because they can make money.
Simperant said, damn, I'm DMing her.
All right, go for it, Simperant.
He got a lot of money.
You got a lot of money.
Yeah,
I
got money.
Okay.
This is my second time here, guys. I love it. I agree with almost everything, if not everything. And it's a great experience. I love it.
Thank you for the support.
Thank you.
You guys could say it's okay to critique or say I don't like it. Because it's okay. We don't mind.
It's like my fourth time here.
Yeah.
You guys keep that shit G and H, like, all the way through.
Maya, where can they find your music real quick?
Yeah.
Plug all your stuff. You can find it on www.slwjmz.net. Also, my site is set up, so you can chat me at any time from anywhere in the world.
Bam! Right
there. And wait. Sorry, go ahead, Mark.
Go ahead. You got something, Chris?
And raise your hand if Maya invited you to the show. Right?
There you go.
Shout out to that.
And you guys are going to see Maya on the show more often. She keeps it real, keeps it a stack all the time. Man. And it's always a pleasure to have you, Maya.
Shout out to Maya.
Thank you for coming.
I was saying, you guys wake up a lot of people from being delusional. The women who are delusional as hell, the men who play in delusion become more delusional than the women that they
become woke.
Yes.
She was spending some game on, on chicks like taking advantage of men, man. So guys, go ahead and check out that episode. Shout out to Maya. Thank you for coming.
Miss Haiti.
Hi. I mean, it's my first time, but there's some parts where I felt like,
you didn't like it. I understand. That's like, uncomfortable, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I feel like I also learned because I love to hear different people's perspectives.
Thank you.
It just puts me, like, it humbles me, and I like to understand shit from different point of view. So I enjoyed myself, really.
Yeah. The last time I was on here, I swear to God, you guys were talking about friend zoning. And the question was, do you think friend zoning is good?
Yeah.
I swear to God, after that show, I went through my whole entire mail list just to find out that those are not really my friends.
Hey!
They all want to, in some way or shape or form, smash.
They want to smash.
Only one of them was really a friend. But if I know for a fact in the back of my mind, if at any point in time I offered.
He going to smash.
Exactly.
We were going to fuck with you guys. I thought about it. We were going to give you guys all your phones back and be like, text all your male friends and tell them you're horny right now. Let's see what happened.
Right.
I'll tell you this. Most of the time, the guys fail
always
miserably.
Fail.
Almost always
Once
fail.
Once they find out it's not a joke, they're like, come through right now. Where you at?
I literally went through my list and was like, okay, I have to break this out. Don't friend zone guys. So I broke all of those off.
There you go.
This is my first time on the podcast and I really enjoyed it. Obviously, there's a lot that I didn't agree with, as you guys saw, but I don't know. I just think not everyone is looking for this specific kind of relationship, and that's fine. And I'm kind of young, so maybe in a few years, my outlook on life and relationships changes. But right now, there's a decent amount I disagree with you on, but there's also things that I agree and was like, yeah, that makes sense, or that explains a lot of my relationships and stuff like that. So I don't know.
Thank you for being respectful. Yeah, and you know, there's nothing wrong with disagreeing, guys. Like, people say, oh, Myron, you kick people off when they disagree with you. Absolutely not. She disagrees with a bunch of things that we said, and it's cool. I think it's very important to have this discourse, and thank you for being respectful.
She's like, very respectful.
Yeah, but like Elle said, like, it's so nice hearing like other perspectives, and like even you guys, like, obviously we didn't agree on everything, but I think it's interesting to see how like other people live and experience relationships. Cool. And stuff.
Thank you for being a good sport and open-minded. Thank you.
So it's my first time on this podcast. Y'all are lit.
Thank you.
But it's lit. Y'all got the baddies. Y'all got the good questions. You got the chat going. So I like that y'all are professional. You listen to, like, y'all are actually listening to women. That shit is rare. Y'all are real. What you guys said all makes sense. Different perspectives make sense. I love that energy. It's like we all, you learn something new every day.
If you decide you want to have kids, let us know.
No.
It made me think about a lot of the things that I've accepted or absorbed, basically, in my lifetime. Basically, the things that you take in from just media in general, things you accept from men, things that men accept from you. It's just the whole, fucking monsoon of shit that goes on in my head during this whole entire conversation.
Hopefully we can clarify some things for you, connect to some dots.
You got a lot going on in your head. I can tell.
I'm so sorry, but like
I have to go pee. Go ahead. What about?
No, it's my first time on the show, but I really liked it because y'all kept it a book. Y'all kept it like straightforward. There was some things that I disagreed on, but when y'all said the other things that, like, I had my opinion, you had yours, and once you said your opinion, then it made sense, and then you put two and two together, and you're like, all right,
a lot of women, when I first say something, they'll like disagree, and then I'll explain, and they'll be like, okay, that makes sense.
Because everybody has their own opinion, but once you hear somebody else's opinion, if you are intelligent enough and mature enough, you'll put yourself in somebody else's shoes to see their opinion.
I saw you nodding to a lot of the things I was saying.
Yeah, so because it makes sense. Like, I actually agree with it.
And I'll say this too. Thank you, ladies, for being good sports and being open-minded. Like I said, there's nothing wrong with disagreeing and everything like that. But, you know, I think it's important to be able to have these conversations and tell. Because the thing is this, ladies, I'm sure you guys know this. I might have said some things that shocked you or surprised you. But the reason why is because a lot of guys lie to get laid.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So they're going to give you the sweet nothings. Nice. They're going to tell you, I'm not like these other guys, and I'll never cheat on you. And you know what I'm saying? Just like,
that's your first line.
Yeah, we keep it very real here.
A man is only as faithful as his options, ladies. That's why I tell you, if a man has money and he has status, you better be prepared to share him with other women sexually. His commitment is when he's willing to die for you and protect you.
But Mara.
Yeah. Nat to Black, didn't you run someone over?
Me? Yeah, but I had the right to do that. When you're in a very abusive relationship is verbally and physically abusive, and that's your first relationship, and they try to run all over you because you have nowhere else to go, you have a right to do that.
Okay. I second that. She hit him with the So guys, these are the lovely ladies' Instagrams. They're below. They're all going to be linked below.
And they also tagged in our Instagram story. Fit Miami.
And fuck with Maya's music. Support her. Yep. She's a part of the team now. So support her. And then also, guys, ladies, I want to come on the show. Chris, can you give them the quick little thing?
Yeah, ladies, send me a DM. Let me know when you're available. If you're flying in, let me know ahead of time. And I'll more or less can tell you when you can be on the show. But I will give it about a day or two. And you go from there, okay? And if you're buying a ticket, please tell your husband
or your brother.
Don't just buy it and all of a sudden he's like, why are you buying tickets to Miami?
Yeah, ladies, if you have a boyfriend or a husband and you want to bring him with you, we have no problem with that. We have a spectator section. We tell you guys all the time, as a man, if you're, you know, when you're with a woman, she can't be doing shit on her own, especially coming on a podcast like this by herself. Yeah. We're cool with that.
He ain't coming on the show, but he can sit here and
watch the show and everything like that, you know? So totally cool.
But guys, get the course.
Yes.
It's out for 5 more days, I believe.
Yes.
And this is the best Instagram course ever made. Branding, also networking, getting girls from anywhere in the world, and also how to set up a good profile with good followers.
And also,
and our sponsor, Manscaped. Yeah. Guys, shave your balls, shave your face.
Let's get that on camera real quick. Make sure you're clean.
Hey,
right there. Your balls. Thank you, guys.
Do it for your balls.
Your balls and your girl will thank you.
Yeah, guys. You know,
actually,
manscaped.com, code fresh and fit, 20% off free shipping.
And then fun fact, when you shave the hair, you actually grow a couple inches.
That is true.
Your help you live longer.
I'm telling you, man.
I know some people that need to shave.
It's nutritious, right? It's
true. The better for the
lady. She looks so disturbed.
I don't know about
the
inches.
The better for the lady.
Cool. All right. Any other super chats?
Nope.
All right. Cool. Guys, thank you so much. We will catch you guys on Monday. We're taking a weekend off.
Yep.
I hope you guys enjoyed this show.
July 4th weekend. We live in Miami.
Yeah, man.
Hey.
All right, guys. Peace.
Peace.